Hello.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to PoleChef. I see there's a couple of you guys in there already. Law of Tsunami, nice getting in early. Welcome back. So tonight we are making something very different for our meal. We're going with spaghetti squash and meatballs, and we're going to do roasted garlic kale in the oven. So this is, yeah, we got some, what, elephant garlic?
Yes.
This is the, I'm going to bring this in real quick. This is the head. It is as big as my fist, and cloves are like this big, gigantic fuck all garlic. So that's going to be fun to play with.
And chop.
Yeah, you're going to have a good time with that. Mm-hmm. All right. So as is tradition, we start every episode with booze. What are we drinking tonight?
Let me go get it.
So for those of you who are just joining, if anybody's new here, hi, I'm Alana, I'm the Pole Chef. This is our sous chef, Steve, our resident prep ninja, and booze fetcher.
That's me.
usually every episode we start off with some kind of alcohol, usually beer, because that's the kind of people that we are. Last time we did a really nice, it was a porter, right?
Yeah,
we usually hover somewhere around porters and stouts because that's kind of what we really like most. But I think this time we're going to try something a little different, mostly because we had a surplus of alcohol, which is rare, but we're going to try something new.
Can you hear it?
You hear the clanks?
Clankety clank. All right.
So what do we got for tonight?
All right. What we have for tonight is we have a Blue Moon Iced Coffee Blonde. We'll bring it up.
Get it in for that sexy close-up.
The Blue Moon Iced Coffee Blonde. It's beer and coffee. How could you go wrong?
I don't think you could go wrong. What's the category of beer? Blue Moon is
blonde.
Like...
It's
blonde.
Yeah, this is the category.
This is the category. All right. And these are
5.4% alcohol. Very drinkable.
Convenient twist off caps.
That's right.
Oh, that's actually really good. I don't know what I expected it to taste like, but...
I don't know. I had a cough drop in before I took a sip.
It's kind of tainted the...
Boy, let me tell you, that's an interesting blend right there.
It tastes like almost like a light beer, an ale of some kind, but there's definitely hints of coffee to it. I'm not sad.
You know what? It's kind of like, what if they burnt Blue Moon?
All right. I can drink yours.
No, I like it. Okay. I'm not complaining.
I like a little carbon with my moon.
I like a little carbon with my everything. Just about everything, yeah.
All right.
Why is it so delicious?
So... first things first, we already have the oven preheated for the first stage because the kale and the squash need to be in the oven at two different temperatures. So this will also be an episode that displays an exercise in time management because we've got three different things that go for three different times at multiple temperatures. So this is going to get a little crazy. So we have the oven preheated, so we're going to do the kale first, which means we're going to need to clear this whole thing off.
Clearing it.
We're going to chop it up, get some garlic with it, and then roast the shit out of it in the oven.
And we love you too, Law of Tsunami. Thanks for joining us.
Aw, thanks, loves. Hi, OBX Pirate. We are making spaghetti squash with roasted kale and meatballs. We're going to, this is the episode where I piss off all the Italians I know.
Sweet.
Because I'm going to make a red sauce, not from a jar. We'll see how it turns out. But I'm hoping that,
Ooh, this is filthy.
Here. Paper towel.
I'm just gonna wash it off.
Okay. I am hoping that this recipe turns out well because I actually got the recipe from one of my favorite food streamers, Binging with Babish, who is just awesome and you should go watch his stuff also, shameless plug. And it's basically a 1 hour sauce, so we're gonna start off, cook some of the vegetables in it, and then add the tomatoes and let it simmer for most of the stream, so we're gonna get that done early. Yes, all hail King Babish. Daddy Babish. All right, fresh board.
What are we doing first?
We're doing, We're doing this. I'm just going to present this to you as it is for dramatic effect.
Okay.
A literal mountain of kale. I think this is more kale than we even did last time. This is quite literally a forest of kale.
I can hide behind a big bush.
So I'm going to have you grab the big ass bowl down there, because we're going to end up putting it in that big ass bowl down there. Those have been rinsed off.
Okay.
We're going to chop them into smaller beads.
But I'll need to take them off of their
straps. Yeah. So we'll need to de-stem them and chop them. Do you want me to just bring it to you?
No, just leave it like that.
Okay. You just chuck it.
Yeah. Just hurl things.
There's also a plastic bag here for things like that also.
Oh, I see.
For small shit. Yeah. Okay, so. God, I'm like all over the place.
Hurl garbage off screen.
Okay. So, since we're going with the Italian theme here, I want to know, has anybody else made a red sauce from scratch? How did you do it? Did you fuck it up? And if you didn't, how many times have you made it since that time? That's what I know. That's what I want to know. Have you ever made a red sauce before?
Yes.
You have?
I have.
Was it for shits and giggles with a blue apron? What was the context?
It was, yeah, a blue apron recipe.
Yeah.
And turned out quite well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan. The quick ones are usually more fresh and bright.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that go longer, the longer everything simmers and, as Babish likes to say, gets to know each other. You got the deep, rich flavors, and I think we're going for somewhere in a happy medium because we're not going to simmer it for like a year. But I'm really excited. And, and the meatballs. I'm really excited for the meatballs because we're going to stuff them with mozzarella pearls. And they're going to be oozy and delicious.
I like pearls in my meat.
Yes, I also like pearls in my meat that ooze when they're
cheese.
Cooked. Pearls of cheese. Very important.
You know what else we're going to be doing forever?
Chopping kale?
Picking kale off the stem.
Do you want help?
You could just stand there and drink if you want.
I could. I could. But where's the
look,
fun in
once
that?
We get to the cooking part, that's all I'm going to do.
Right,
so.
That's fair. It's only fair.
It is an
and Oliver's just going to, like, hover and hope that I drop stuff. We already know he likes kale and carrots.
The dog will eat greens.
Hi, thank you. Hello, Libby. I see you and your family. Tell them I said hello. She's broadcasting in a public place, apparently.
Well, hello, public people.
Meatballs, pork neck bones. I know. Yeah. You owe me a turn in the kitchen because I got to learn how to make that shit. I haven't forgotten. Pork neck bones. Too legit. Okay. God, this is so much kale.
So much. And not too much.
And we can stop and do like just a bowl's worth if you want.
I mean, you said two bunches of kale.
I did.
I brought two bunches
of kale. I did indeed. I underestimated the size of a bunch according to Harris Teeter.
Hmm. Well, whenever you think it's enough.
Just tell me to say when as regards an Italian dish?
Yes.
It's not cheese, so I think we'll be okay.
And this is also not the Olive Garden, so.
Also true.
Because.
No, I like to look them dead in the eye and dare them to stop grating the cheese.
Does anybody still like the Olive Garden?
I don't know. That's a good question. I haven't been in like a really, really long. Does anybody watching still like? Yes, when is never.
Yeah.
Does anybody that's watching still go to Olive Garden on purpose and not because you got shanghaied? Also, please props to our mod. Larry is upstairs corralling you crazy fucks. And also props to our new sound guy, Seth, in the background making everything happen musically. I think this might be enough.
Yeah, you think? Are you sure?
I think it might
be. You don't want to have too little kale.
Don't forget the kale. Okay. I'm going to put this
the rest of that away?
Somewhere that's else.
All right. We're just going to go with this much kale.
Yes. Okay, so we've ripped it all up.
Really
it's already been, it's like crunchy and curly. Mm-hmm. It feels like it's made of plastic, but it's not.
I know.
It's neat. Like it should be a display garnish.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we're going to chop garlic.
I thought I was chopping the kale.
You are also chopping the kale. We're going to chop the garlic and chop the kale. And, okay, go ahead.
No, no, move your hand. This is going to be fine.
Momentum.
Hey!
Oppa!
All right.
Okay.
And.
Yeah, I'm usually a Shanghai. Oh, it's a perfect dome.
It's like
I feel like this is one of those weird like Jello mold things from the 70s, where they
right?
just like, what can we put in Jello? We'll make that as
it looks
a dish.
Like a, it looks like a hairdo from the
70s. It kind of does. All right. Knives.
Knife. I need.
They're down there.
Yeah. I guess this one will work.
Do you want a different knife?
I want a bigger knife if you have one, honestly.
I do. I have a bigger knife.
I mean, they come in all shapes and sizes. Those are actually about the same size, but I'll just take that one.
Okay.
I think
it's
this
a
is
little
like
heavier
a,
in the handle, so it'll be a little easier to.
This is a meat knife.
That is actually an all-purpose chef's knife. The meat knife is really long and skinny.
Oh, right.
I will move this out of here. And retrieve my own elbow.
Gosh.
And just double fist it like a champ.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to really squeeze it all down like I like to. It's just so goddamn much.
That's okay. When we roast it down, they'll shrink and crisp up a little bit. And we've got two pans specifically because we'll need all of the room. This is what happens when you feed four people. Your portions
I'm fairly
become ridiculous.
This could feed a lot more than four people.
Well, this is also preparing for, like, you know, this is also an exercise in mild meal prep where you make, like, a whole shit ton of something intentionally so you have stuff left over. Yes. Gross face to the Jell-O molds. I don't know what the 1960s, 70s obsession with Jell-O molds was, but, like, they would put fucking anything in Jell-O and just call that a meal. Jesus Christ. Oh my god.
We've got extra! We've got extra!
Oliver's
the hell with it.
Oliver's going fucking ham.
He'll
right
get it
now.
All.
Oliver is our resident mascot. He will make an appearance later in the stream.
Alright.
He likes to come around the kitchen and... I think you have sufficiently chopped the fuck out of
take
that
the
kale.
Beer back.
Yeah.
And, bowl.
Bowl. Libby Crying Socks, thank you for following. Ooh, soup season. I have been trying to come up with good soup and stew ideas. We have a crock pot. We used to have a rice maker. It wasn't quite an Instapot, but it was like a legit rice maker. But I always wanted to experiment with those like Instapot soups and stuff. I've seen some pretty interesting recipes that...
All right. A bowl of leaves.
Fucking leaves. The food that my food eats. All right, so next up... No, Oliver. He's having just a fucking ball with... All of this, it's like that Cards Against Humanity card, all of this blood,
yeah.
But it's all of this kale.
All of this kale. I didn't get nearly as much on the floor as I thought I was going to get.
No. All right, so next up is the giant fuck all garlic.
Right.
So we did get regular garlic as well, but we also have the monster elephant garlic, mm-hmm. because honestly, why the fuck not? I always say every stream that garlic is just a mere suggestion. If it tells you you need two cloves, you need six. So we just decided to increase the size of our cloves.
It's a big ass clove.
That is a big ass clove. I think we will do...
How many cloves?
One clove.
One?
Yes.
Singular clove.
Singular clove. Because we're going to mix it in with the kale.
This is Look. One golf ball of garlic.
That is One clove.
Yes.
That is insane. Is that going to fit in the press?
No.
Are you going to chop it like a normal person?
I will make it up as I go along.
Perfect. That's the whole point of the stream. So, absolutely in spirit. All right.
Yep.
Oh,
still need to hit it.
Mobius Row, thank you for following. Welcome, welcome.
What up, Mobius of the Row? With the following.
Just keeping up with these trap
games. You really got it. Whack!
Right. Jesus. That's like an apple.
Will not break.
It broke.
It has broken. Yeah. Yeah, it is like an apple. Just take a big bite out of it.
I'll pass. Hard pass. I'm not one of those people that can get down with chewing on raw garlic. I was burned once. Never again. Oh, Pole Chef question time. Yeah, what is my favorite season of what?
What?
Or are we asking them? It's not helpful.
Who?
Ooh, mac and cheese. Fuck yeah, mac and cheese. We're definitely gonna do a mac and cheese episode at some point as well. Filament Buster, hello.
Is there a...
Oh, season, like, weather. I pay attention.
Yeah.
What are you looking for? Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
My garlic press. Which the elephant deer garlic will now fit into. A few at a time.
So, our garlic press, for anybody who's new here, like many things on our show, kitchen gadget-wise or kitchen equipment-wise, is not sponsored by, but heavily... prevalent.
It's fine.
Okay. Our garlic press is from OXO. We love their shit.
Best garlic press ever.
This thing is
shit. Okay, don't eat that.
That's not gonna be.
Don't rinse that off.
Yeah. Don't give that to the dog.
No. No garlic for dogs.
Yeah, that'll be a bad time.
Don't do it. It's a bad time.
I'm gonna have a bad time. But yeah, OXO makes some really amazing shit. They usually have like a more affordable, cheaper option of a thing, and then like a really hefty, heavy-duty option of a thing. Always go for the heavy-duty option of a thing because it's fucking worth it. Ooh, yes, Mobius, please, thank you. And yes, definitely please send us some of your soup recipes.
Oh, yeah.
We're definitely into that shit. Down the road, we'll have... some special episodes where we'll be able to make some of the recipes that you guys send to us. So please send me all the stuff. I want to know about your grandma's apple pie and your secret soups. Everything. What's your favorite season? Mine is definitely fall.
My favorite season?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. They're all good for different reasons, I suppose.
That's fair.
Like, you know, spring is cool because it's like not winter.
And then... Most seasons are cool because they're not winter.
Yeah, but winter's cool because it's winter.
Boo.
I don't know.
Sudden puns. Food puns.
It's probably fall. But I like summer a lot.
So eloquent. I like fall also. Basic bitch. Not necessarily super into the pumpkin everything that always accompanies fall. But I like fall because that's when the bugs die. And I'm a super big fan of that. Because I hate bugs.
Bugs are also dead in the winter.
That's, you know what? Okay, that's fair. I'm a polar bear, so I would say either fall or winter. Neither spring or summer excite me. All right. So we're going to put all of that in with the kale.
There's a lot of garlic.
Oh, it's a lot of kale.
True. There you go.
All right. So we're going to bring this over here.
I'm going to rinse off my filthy cutting board.
I'm gonna try and like spread this out a little bit. This is gonna get mixed probably with my hands because I don't really have a better way to do that. We're gonna do olive oil, salt, and pepper as well. Yeah, centrally massage the kale.
You really gotta just get in there,
like,
work
really
around.
Use your fingers.
Yeah, just really. Always wash your hands before.
Before and after.
This is also how we used to make the tuna fish.
at Subway?
Yeah. Years ago, when I worked at Subway, eat fresh.
God.
Oh, no. Don't eat the tuna fish.
Which is sad, because that was my favorite.
Yeah.
This is
what you do. Yeah. You just get a 2-pound can of mayonnaise and a 2-pound can... No. Jar of mayonnaise and a can of tuna. Mm-hmm. And you just sit there and just...
Squish.
Really get...
Here, I'm going to add some food lubricant in there for you.
So good. Just work that... Oh, yeah, that changes the texture a bit.
Yeah, nice and slick.
This is...
Silky.
This is getting... do we have, like, a PG rating we're trying not to...
No, we are absolutely the fuck not.
Oh, good.
Not on my watch.
Yeah, I think I just discovered I have a small cut on one of my fingers.
No.
That feels great.
That feels really great.
Mm. Yeah.
All right, we're going to add some salt and pepper.
Go ahead.
All
right. Right, yeah, the garlic found it.
Mm. Yeah, garlic found it, salt's gonna make it worse.
Oh, I don't get any of my nail polish off in there. But, you know, it'd be fine. Yeah.
So, this will also be fun to experiment with because I have done something fancy to the pepper.
Surprise. What the hell did you do?
So, the pepper that we get, because we have a grinder, we get the peppercorns whole. And one thing you can do to kind of increase the flavor profile of the peppercorns is toast them lightly. Don't burn them. Very important. Kind of like last episode when we toasted the pecans for the chicken. You can toast the peppercorns in a dry pan, tiny bit of olive oil, and it... Okay. Sticky.
It's not very sticky. It's quite lubed.
Tiny bit of olive oil. Toast them like medium high or so for maybe 5 to 10 minutes. Ooh, I haven't tried... Hi, Sarah Dwin. Welcome back.
Hello.
I haven't tried pink peppercorns. I have heard of them. They're on my list of shit. Oh, God.
God damn it.
Why is the sink always on all the way hot when you're washing your hands?
I don't know.
T-Rex arms. I got a big head and little arms. I don't really think this is thought out that well. Master. All right.
Yeah.
So we have our tossed greens.
Toss them.
So now we're going to stick them on a pan. Let's wipe off this board first.
Yeet.
Yeet. Take towels. I will take the bowl.
Bowl.
I'm just going to bring this right over the sink again.
Okay. So with these, because we have so much fucking kale, we've got 2 aluminum foil lined sheets. I've got a grate on here for the spaghetti squash for later, for the moment, but I'm also going to spray them down with olive oil cooking spray to lubricate them. An actual civet. Hi, I love your username. That's amazing. Someone did say tossed greens.
I tossed them. I tossed
them
so well.
Tossed the shit out of those greens. So this is the olive oil spray that we use. It's from a company called Brandless, which by telling you that it's brandless, I feel like defeats the point. But I got it online, and it was like $3 and for like 3 cans. So I've got olive oil spray for days. Okay. So now I will hold this.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just gonna like empty it onto both of these sheets, and then they're gonna go right into the oven.
Okay.
All right. So you wanna try and get them in as close to one layer as possible.
Which one of these was mine?
The colder one.
It's true.
So with this much kale, it'll probably be a little difficult, sink, to get them all into like a single layer, but you kind of want them to spread out as much as you can. If they crowd the pan, they'll steam too much, which is also why we add a little bit of oil so that they'll crisp up around the edges, because that's what we want. So we have our garden of kale. These are gonna go into the oven for about 20 minutes. We're gonna check on them periodically. step away to let the oven do its blasty blast thing.
All right, I guess one of these is significantly colder than the other.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Beer is beer, man.
That's true.
Okay, we're gonna do upper and lower third of the oven. We're gonna let that go. I'm gonna set a timer for 20 minutes. Okay, so that's gonna go. Calm kitchen.
I know.
Such serene. Much cooked.
I don't even want to do anything.
Just hang lounge.
Out. Enjoy the sounds.
Unfortunately.
Shit! I gotta work!
God damn it, I gotta do stuff.
Damn it. Okay.
Alright, so next up, we are going to do the meatballs.
Meatballs.
We're going to make the meatballs.
Yes.
And then I think we will also prep the squash.
Right.
Because we're trying to do this thing where we don't make the camera go back and forth to the stove all the time. So we're going to do all the prep over here and then move to the stove and cook everything. So let's get meatball shit. So we've got ground beef. A tube of ground beef. We've got...
There we go.
Some fucking
that
garlic.
That was satisfying. More garlic.
Breadcrumbs. Yeah, we're gonna use like a tiny clove because we are gonna make quite a bit of meatballs.
I did get regular garlic too.
That is true.
Want to use that instead?
No.
Okay.
don't eat the tomatoes yet. What else am I missing?
You know, it tastes the same. It's just
there's just more of it.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I know, but I like it.
Okay.
It's just novel.
Okay.
Okay. So we've got beef. We're gonna put the salt. Salt is always with me. Okay, I think that's it. All right, so because we are actually using a webcam to stream this time, tube of beef, one fuck ton of garlic. Yeah, that's really it. That's beef, garlic, put them in a ball, and that's it. Cheese.
Cheese.
Cheese. And if you could grab a mesh sieve from up there so that we can drain this. So what we are stuffing these with... are basically...
The little one?
No.
The big one?
Yes. There we go. Sancho? Are these pearls in Laura? We got two of these fuckers, because, you know, why not? So basically we're going to make the meatball meat mix, and then we're going to put like a thumb in it and then like put one of the cheese balls in it and then like seal it back up so that when it's cooked it oozes cheese. It's gonna be great. Okay, so first things first.
With balls of meat.
Balls of meat with balls of cheese.
And we're shoving our thumb into the meat.
Yep, and then shoving
filling
cheese.
Filling the crevasse.
With ooze.
With cheese.
Yes. Which will then ooze.
Sounds delicious.
It's gonna be great. So first we're gonna drain the mozzarella.
Draining.
So we've got a mesh sieve and a bowl. To do that with. And yes.
What's the meshive?
The meshive.
You have a meshive for me?
I must ask you a question. So because I'm not streaming with my phone anymore, props to this one and also to Larry for helping get this kitchen all fucking set up. I can now use this to look at my fucking recipes. So I'm working from about 3 or 4 different recipes, so I'm gonna be jumping back and forth between all of these as we go. Do you require
the
assistance?
The top is stronger than the plastic. Like, look at this. I'm pulling the plastic and it's just.
Oh, God.
Pulling the whole.
That is some seriously sealed cheese.
Right? The seal is much stronger.
Don't.
I'm pulling the
whole. I'm waiting for you to squirt all over the webcam. Phrasing? Phrasing. I think.
There goes our PG rating.
Right? Yeah, doesn't it sound fucking divine? It's gonna be great.
A knife.
Now that's a knife. Alright. So, essentially what we're gonna do is one ball of mozzarella per meatball.
Right.
Do we think that this many balls of cheese is going to be enough meatballs for the four of us, or should we do the second tub as well?
That's a lot of damn meatballs.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I think that's enough.
Okay, perfect. I always prefer to buy more than I need because I also know I fucking love fresh mozzarella and I will absolutely snack on this later.
Fresh mozzarella is amazing.
Hello! Greetings. Greetings.
From Utah.
Yeah.
Ah.
All over the fucking country tonight.
Pseudo soldat? I can't.
Go for it. Let's play pronounce the username.
Pseudo soldat, yeah.
There you go.
There we go.
Thank you, Love Tsunami. Good looking out.
For all right. What?
Can
what?
You he helped us with the pronunciation. Oh. I think.
Oh. Yeah. There we go.
Alright, so I'm gonna dump this and then put these back in the bowl.
Have you ever been to Utah?
I have been to Salt Lake City once when I was a kid. When I was in high school, we did a trip across the country following the Lewis and Clark Trail.
Uh-huh.
And we went all the fuck over because my godmother, my godsister also had family in like Wyoming and Oregon and like all of that downward area. So on our way down, we slipped through Salt Lake City. It was a lot of fun.
Sounds like
from what I remember anyway.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we need a bowl for the meat. And since we only really had veggies and garlic in here.
Meatball. For the meatball.
Exactly. Can you hand me a paper towel?
Yes.
Because I'm not going to make the same mistake I did last time and use my towel for meat. So we won't be yelled at in my own kitchen. Unless I ask nicely. All right. So, meat in there.
The whole thing?
The whole log. Do you need a... Nope, you're good.
How do you...
I assume kitchen shears. But, you know, whatever feels right, I guess. Just don't... Sure. I guess just don't whack it like you do with a roll of, like,
just
croissants. We're very violent in this kitchen. It's how we cope with being adults. Also, we drink a lot. Okay, so apparently we did pronounce it right. Thank you, Love Tsunami, for helping out with the pronunciation. Oh, geez. Okay. God, that is a lot of meat.
That is a lot. 3 pounds.
3 pounds of fucking meat.
Can we each eat a pound of meatballs?
I believe so.
I
believe in us.
I usually eat 4 meatballs.
You know how much.
All right.
The rest of us. Okay, so we've got meat.
I have to stick my hands in this too.
You don't have to. I know how much you hate that. I can do that if you prefer.
Okay.
Is this where you want to tag out?
I mean, yeah. I don't want to. I'm just gonna say I don't want to.
Okay. Tag out.
I like meat. I like
consent
cheese.
Consent in the kitchen is very important. Okay, so we've got Italian seasoning, which I feel is like kind of a cop-out, but it's in the recipe, so, you know, we'll fucking do that.
Because, yeah, we're clearly professional.
We're super duper professional, and everybody should listen to what we do.
I mean, we make good shit.
That's true. Our food does not end up half bad. All right, so, seasoning, salt, pepper.
No one's gotten sick from it yet.
That's it. We don't need these. Those can go back in the...
Oh, what is that?
They're Italian spice breadcrumbs.
Oh.
But...
We don't need them.
We don't need them, nor do we need the eggs, apparently.
What?
Yeah.
Alright. Sorry, eggs.
There are some recipes that call for eggs in your meatballs, and this is not one of them. Oh, God.
Hmm?
Whopped a meat on a counter! Okay. So... We're basically just gonna fucking season these. That's literally it, and then stuff them with cheese. All right. So, I am not doing measurements because I feel like I know what a certain amount is based on the amount of meat that we have, and I don't know, it makes me feel closer to being Italian even though I am 0% Italian.
I trust you to know how to season the meat.
Perfect. All right. I will want a little bit of garlic. Though, so if you want to pick out like the smallest clove of that head,
right here.
Perfect.
I can make some more garlic.
Okay.
That's easy enough.
Yeah.
It doesn't involve sticking my hands in meat.
You get desensitized to it after a while.
I will fondle the bush all day, but the meat, I don't know.
No meat squeezing for you?
It's just It's a texture thing, I think.
That's fair. Plus, it gets like under your fingernails and.
Right. It's gross.
It's really just.
It's so squishy.
And just wait, no, but just listen to the sound. Pause on the piano for a minute. I want to see if the God Mike will pick this up. I want to know if you guys hear this. I don't know how sensitive it is. Okay, go ahead. You're good. You can keep playing. Squish! Squish! And this is a pretty decent fat percentage too, so it's not too like, not too lean, it's not too fatty. I think these will sear down pretty fucking good. All right, so once we have our garlic, I'll mix that in, and then I'll basically make like little golf ball sized balls and then shove cheese in them and then seal them up, and I'm gonna set them aside. Kniffy.
Yeet.
Yes, I said squish. Squinchy. Okay.
Perfect. Enough?
Yep, that's good.
Sweet.
So I'm just gonna mix in the garlic liberally. Don't need too much, because there's gonna be garlic in the sauce and garlic in the everything else, so. All things in moderation except garlic. Oh, Kniffy, yeah. It's a thing that my mom used to say. All right, so now that is sufficiently. Okay, so now what I need a little bit of water in there.
Okay.
And also one of those silver dishes that I usually put meat on that's to the left of you.
Just water?
Yeah, just water. It's for my hands.
Oh.
It makes it easier to roll smooth balls.
Right. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's good.
A little warm.
That's fine. I'm not like soaking them, it makes it easier to form the silver plate underneath the garlic and the tongs and the bread and stuff. Just one of those. So I can put the actual meatballs on top of it. See, to write me out. Write me out! Alright. So, I am not doing this any particular way except just grabbing like basically a palm's worth. And I'm just getting like my fingertips kind of wet to make it easier to like ball shape these between my hands. Because when you have a lot of meat, especially if the meatballs contain any kind of like egg or breadcrumbs, it makes them extra tacky. So it makes it hard to get like a smooth surface on them.
Big meatball. Do they shrink?
A little bit, yeah. When they sear, they'll like reduce down. But I also need them to be. So I'm just gonna stick my finger in, and I'm gonna make like a little hole in the center. And I'm just gonna shove in a little mozzarella ball. And then just keep, I'm gonna pinch it so that it doesn't break a seal, and then just roll it out. Because I don't want any holes in this, because then if I have holes in this and I sear it, the cheese is gonna fucking melt out, and that's no good. So how's everybody doing tonight? I heard a couple of you guys were making, the water trick. I learned that, God, I don't remember when, a long, long time ago. Probably, I used to watch like the Food Network and Cooking Channel and all that shit growing up. So I've picked up little stuff here and there. Variations on other variations. So yeah, what are you guys making tonight? I know somebody said, I think Lost Tsunami, you said you made mac and cheese. Mac and cheese with hot dogs. Fucking classic, man. That's like good old fashioned mac and cheese. Was it Kraft mac and cheese, or was it like Velveeta, or did you make it? Oh, and over here you making the fucking fucking OBX over here, like, I made homemade mac and cheese with kielbasa. Kielbasa sausage. Kraft. Oh, Annie's, yeah. Annie's has some pretty good fucking mac and cheese. Their white cheddar mac is really fucking good.
Welcome to the stream, courtesy farts. We appreciate the courtesy of giving us a follow.
Thank you for the follow, courtesy farts. That's fantastic. Grilled teriyaki chicken with steamed broccoli almondine. Oh, that's fucking fancy. What exactly is almondine? Is that just like putting almonds with your food? Is that just a fancy way of saying cook it with almonds? You're welcome, love, Tsunami. The weeb is welcome here. Yeah. All right, so now anytime that we have to make stuff with almonds, we can just call it almondine. Suddenly a prep ninja. What is, okay, so PoleChef question time. What is the most complicated recipe you've ever made? And did it work out? That's more important. Okay, Log Tsunami, you are going to have to explain what the fuck that is, because it sounds fancy, but I don't know how to pronounce it. So therefore, I have to know what it is. Goose for Christmas. Oh shit, like a whole fucking goose? Oyakodon. Oh shit. Okay, yeah, it's kind of simple, but I can imagine it's a little time intensive. Dairy-free chocolate chia pudding. You know, actually, that sounds really good. I tried to do a coconut chia pudding. I don't know, for anybody who's Northern Virginia local, for anybody who's ever been to First Watch, they have that like coconut vanilla chia pudding stuff with the granola and the fruit and shit. And like, I love getting that stuff. I tried to make it at home one time and it was really good, but I never had the time to remake it again, and I just forgot about it. I don't know. We don't live near one anymore. So, like, I don't know. I guess it'll happen eventually. Tons of goose fat in the freezer. Oh, shit, yeah. I did a couple of episodes ago, actually the first Twitch edition of PoleChef, we cooked duck because apparently you guys were a bunch of bougie shits and wanted to watch me render duck fat for 2 hours. So we did that, and we still have a crap ton of duck fat left over that we should probably use in stuff.
Sure.
Because reasons.
That's the thing people like.
Yeah. Just stick it in there instead of like olive oil.
Never had goose.
I've had goose before for like a, it was like a, like he did it for a Christmas dinner. I had it for Christmas dinner with a family, like, really, really long time ago.
Right.
But I've never made goose. I've never cooked goose before. I imagine it would be very lean, like duck or turkey or something like that. But very crispy on the outside if you do a whole one. Ooh, roasted potatoes. I love any kind of potato, but roasted potatoes are by far some of my fucking favorite. You prefer duck? Why do you prefer duck to goose? Took a lot of babysitting for not great a payout. Fuck goose.
Fuck goose.
You know what? Fuck geese as an animal. I don't know enough about it to compare it as like a food protein, but like,
I think he's just saying fuck geese in general. Because sure. Because they're a giant asshole.
They are giant assholes.
Specifically Canadian.
Specifically the ones at the George Mason campus.
Right.
Because those guys are serial killers.
And
they will track you the fuck down.
But I feel like eating one is, you know,
perfect vengeance.
That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
Sweet justice. So, sweet and savory justice. Damn auto mods. can we take off the auto mod for fuck, please? Because that's gonna happen a lot. Canadian geese. They absorbed all of Canada's aggression. Yeah, that's not too far off. That's why Canadians are so nice.
Right?
They do this, I saw a meme once that was like, they do a ritual every year that like, they put all of Canada's like anger and aggression into the geese every
and
year.
Send them down here.
Right.
I'd buy that.
Yeah. flavor of duck is better, goose dried out easier, and it was way expensive. Yeah, I could definitely see that. All right, so duck over goose. It's good.
I can't even imagine what you're saying there, OBX.
All
pirate.
The more reason.
To, all the more
the
reason.
The motherfuckers?
To,
probably?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fuck the fucking fuckers.
Fuck them fucking fucks. That certainly illustrates the diversity of the word.
Ooh.
Who the fucking? What the fucking? Okay, so we found a way around the Autobahn. Hashtags.
Hashtag.
Okay. So, I'm gonna pause after this meatball because our kale is done.
I have garlic all over me.
That's what happens.
It's just stuck.
It's a clingy bitch. Alright. So I'm gonna wash my hands real quick and then I'm gonna grab the kale. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So much meat. This and see how the kale is doing. Alright. The oven will always blow back. Whoosh! Alright, let's see how this baby's doing.
That looks like some...
Some crispy kale.
Crispy lettuce.
So, it's night... Yeah, go for it.
Oh god. Don't. He's gonna fart himself.
Hit. He's right behind me.
Give it a minute.
Oh, yes. Okay, so this is what the kale looks like now. There is a lot of it, so I'm gonna put it back in for just a little bit longer so that it crisps up a little bit more. So I'm just gonna like shake it and like rearrange it a little bit and then stick it back in the oven. It probably needs another maybe 5 to 10 minutes or so. Yeah, so it's still a little bit wilty, but it has shrunk down considerably, so it will spread out a lot more now.
You can't tell, but she's spreading kale with art and grace.
Daintily. Okay, this is gonna go back in. I'm actually gonna add a little bit more salt because I did under-season it on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
And the salt will help it to shrink a little more as well as it cooks. It's always, you can always add more seasoning, you can never take it away. So definitely err on the side of slightly under-seasoning and then add more to taste at the end. It's better than having the sea in your mouth when you're cooking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right, the second one. Okay, so the bottom ones are a little bit more crispy, but I think there's actually less kale on this one as well. Salt baying on this bitch. Okay. And I know I talked about this briefly last episode, but I really like to brag about my salt. I got this cool little salt thing. This is from one of my best friends, Anthony. If you're watching, thank you. I got flakes because they fancy. Also because the flakes are a lot easier to control and they're like a little sticky. It's a lot harder to over-season with flakes because you have like big chunks and you can crumble them into smaller pieces. If you have like regular table salt, it's a lot easier to over-season shit. So I highly recommend them. These are, ooh, I got a new bucket so I can show you. So I get these Malden salt flakes. They come in a 3-pound tub on Amazon for like $25. This shit will last you so long. I highly do a recommend. Not sponsored. Should sponsor. Okay, so kale's back in the oven. I'm gonna set another timer for about between 5 and 10. I'm gonna go for 7 minutes and split the difference. And we're gonna keep going on these fucking meatballs. We've only got like a little bit of meat left. Fantastic. Always wear an apron when possible.
I found an apron.
I see that you have found an apron.
There you go. OBX Pirate.
OBX Pirate, yes. Yes, that is exactly.
No more garlic on the shirt.
That's perfect. I feel like eventually I need to get a PoleChef logo on an apron or something.
Mm-hmm.
Really like push the brand.
Right.
Really be obnoxious with it. Yes, enough salt to last the zombie apocalypse, basically, because that shit's going to be worth its weight in goddamn gold.
Aw, thank you, courtesy farts. It's really hard to say that. Cute.
Aw. That's a cute.
Push it.
Push the brand! Karyotic, hey, welcome back. Push the... push it. The brand. Yeah.
So what are we doing with the squash when we get to it?
So when we get to the squash, what we're gonna do, so after we do the meatballs, we are gonna set them aside and then we're gonna pull out the squash and we are going to cut them in half lengthwise. See, even women's aprons don't have real pockets.
No, this is terrible.
This is an awful place to be. So with the squash, we're gonna cut them in half and then we are going to liberally lubricate them with food lubricant. And then we are going to season them and roast them for about 40 minutes.
What do you need me to do?
Cut the squash and lubricate them.
How shall I cut them?
Lengthwise.
Okay.
Like hot dogs.
Just cut them.
Yep, right down the middle. Because what will happen after we roast them is the inside.
Roasting them in halves.
Whole. Yep, roasting them in halves. And then what will happen when we're done roasting them is the insides will get soft and you take a fork and you like rake out the insides and then it comes out all like stringy and it looks like spaghetti, which is why it's called spaghetti squash. All
right.
Swear to God, we're almost done with the meatballs. Every episode, there's always something that just takes like forever. Last time it was sauteing kale little bits at a time. This time it's meatballs. Mm. I need a beverage, but my hands are meaty. Can you do an assist? That's fucking teamwork.
No spill. I am contributing.
That's a good sous chef right there.
Even though I gave you the warm one.
Chat, what? Skipping class? Which class? What class? What'd I miss? Ooh, donation challenge. Shit, yes! Donate to the cause! Bring us aprons! Good call, man.
Yes. Pocketlessness is hell. OBX.
Yes.
Although, I don't know. Kind of cute.
Oh, skipping class. Okay. I think it's really the frills that give it the personality.
No,
Just like a little bit of flair.
I don't mind it.
Yeah.
I understand why girls like dresses.
Right? It's it's what I refer to as the whoosh factor.
Yes.
It is completely and I believe entirely derived by villain witches from Disney, a la Maleficent. Because if you've ever worn like a really long flowy skirt or had like a cape or a cloak of some kind or even a blanket wrapped around your shoulders, you can't resist the urge to do the whoosh. It's almost impossible.
Yeah. I can believe that.
Yeah.
It's kind of like wearing a cape.
Exactly so. Yeah, you can't resist the dramatic whoosh.
Cannot.
You can't fight the dramatic whoosh.
Physically impossible.
Yeah, we're definitely going to have a lot of mozzarella left over. But that's fine. Then we can turn them into chef snacks. Because we didn't do that last time.
Wait, no.
Nope. We don't rinse them off first.
We got raw meat all over.
Yeah, don't do that.
I don't think we can... You think rinsing them is going to make it good enough?
Maybe.
I don't know.
PoleChef Pole.
Should we
rinse off and eat our mozzarella balls or no? Yeah, exactly.
I'd like
snake flounce. Exactly. Cape equals snake flounce. Flounce.
Do not rinse the cheese. See?
Ooh. I like the way you fucking think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fry it up. Mm-hmm.
Like tiny little mozzarella sticks, but they're mozzarella balls.
Sure. Slightly meat flavored.
That is a lot of meatballs, and they are huge.
Mm-hmm.
Gosh.
We are going to have extra.
Yeah.
But that's fine, because
we're
going to
be eating this till next week.
Can you check the kale for me while
I'm
doing this? Dexterity check.
What am I checking?
Open them up and just poke it with a spoon and see if you feel more crispiness than flaccidness.
Okay.
Ow!
Careful. Yeah, I hear a crunch. Okay.
Yeah, they're pretty crispy.
Perfect. All right, so if you want to pull that one out, just set it on top of the stove. And then you can dump what's in there on top of the other one as well to save space.
Okay. You guys can't smell this, but it smells amazing.
We really need to get that smell-o-vision thing on lockdown, man.
I'm telling you.
That was really just the height.
We figure that out, we'll be syndicated in no time.
Right?
Syndicated?
Affiliated.
Affiliated.
Right, yeah, we are, so we are on the road to affiliation. Yes. Precisely so. We are aiming for 50 followers. There's a couple more things that we have to do in order to get affiliated, but the start is to get 50 followers. So I can't see it at the moment, but if someone could tell me how many followers we're up to at this point in time. 32?
32. 32?
Who's the
33!
Mod, what's the official number? Because I don't think the bar is right. Yeah.
32.
Results may vary. Just hit the timer button again.
Cancel?
No, because we still need the oven on. Hit the timer button.
Time.
Bottom left. No. Other left. Yeah, that one.
Did I turn the oven off?
I think you did.
Off.
So, hit bake.
No, bake.
Bake. And then it's going to go up to 450.
Okay.
Thank you.
I know how to operate a stove.
So our kale is done, which means we are now going to crank the heat to 450 for our squash, and we're going to have probably a couple minutes to clean up and talk to you guys for a bit while that goes. We are then going to prep. Yeah, good.
Why are you calling me up?
I caught Steve munching on the kale.
I can't see what I'm doing.
Caught Steve munching on the kale. I mean, you wouldn't be a good sous chef if you didn't eat while we cooked. That's like half the fun of cooking yourself. So I've got one tiny meatball just for you.
Oh, sorry.
I can't.
Okay.
I'm
actually not the biggest fan of meatballs. They're good, but in small quantities. That's a large quantity.
That is many meatballs.
But I trust this woman and her abilities to make a tasty meatball. I'm willing to give it a shot.
So kind. Okay. So we've got our plate of meat. God, that is a lot of meatballs. And we have extra cheese. I will set this aside to do something with at some point. I'm not going to rinse it, and we're not going to eat it raw. Don't worry. So the next bit is we are going to prep the squash while the oven is preheating for the squash. All we're going to do is cut them in half long ways, oil them up, salt and pepper. That was so close. That was so close. Oil them up, salt and pepper, and we're going to place them face side down onto a baking pan. We're actually going to reuse one of the pans that the kale was in just to kind of give it a little extra something. Aw, thank you. Share away. 43. Oh, shit. We're at 43 followers, guys. What the fuck?
I don't think I know 43 people.
We only need 7 more.
What?
Go find 7 people. All right.
Quick.
This calls for mascot celebration.
Oliver.
There's a cute dog. There's a cute dog on my stream. Please
follow
tell
for
everyone.
More dog. Do it. He's adorable.
And he will eat. He will. Oh, yeah.
He will eat anything. And yeah. So that's our mascot, Oliver, our resident potato, who answers to potato. And we'll eat literally everything in our kitchen. Okay, so if you could put this over on the thing elsewhere. Cool. Next up, we got Skata Squash.
All right, I get to take over the reins of doing stuff again. You just... I want to say you handed me your melons.
I handed you my
melons, they're squishes.
Squishes?
Squashes.
What's the plural of squash?
Squash? It's gotta be squashes.
Like geese or moose or deer.
Squeesh.
Moose or squeeze. I like it.
Squeeshin'.
Squeeshin'. Squeeshin'. Okay, I'm gonna set these aside somewhere else.
All right.
Okay, so take off the stickers first. Oh, we're not gonna bake the stickers.
Right, because these are superior squish.
Superior squeeshin'?
Squeeshin'. It's like Venetian.
Squeeshin'.
Yeah.
See, it doesn't even say it's a squash. Just says spaghetti. Mm-hmm. Superior. I feel like that could be really misleading.
These are elitist.
So, we will... do you need your... My knife? Your... Okay.
Cool. I have a knife.
That's a knife.
It is a knife.
So we're going to top and tail them. So, just shave the edges off. And then we're going to cut them long ways. They're a bit hefty. I will hold your alcohol.
Thank you! I have no experience.
Be very careful.
With these.
Excellent.
I sort of broke it.
That's fine. And then just write down, yeah, that's probably better.
Yeah. Yeah,
get some oomph in there. Yep, Oliver cameo. It's just squash. Yeah, but yeah, so bougie sketty. Bougie sketty is bougie. That has to hurt. Why are you doing that?
Ah! It worked.
All right, perfect.
See, look at that.
That's excellent.
Beautiful halved.
Halved spaghetti squash.
Squishing.
Maybe, I don't know if you can eat the seeds like you can with pumpkins, but I'd be really curious to try roasting them like pumpkin seeds.
I mean, aren't we
just for shits and giggles.
Aren't they going in the roaster?
They are. We are scooping them out first because we have to scrape out the actual meat of the gourd as the spaghetti part. But I think in addition to and also separate from that, we should scoop out the seeds and then roast those on... Okay, 1 second. Jesus.
Got it.
I'm gonna set these upside down. Okay.
You know that'd be a great
Skitty Squinch.
That'd be a great gag for like the Halloween episodes to have me like
accidentally cut off a finger. Yeah, but see now you gave it away.
Nah, see everybody here will be in on the joke.
Oh, that's true. All the new people, don't tell the new people. If we do some weird shit like that on Halloween, don't tell the new people.
Yeah.
Mmm. I don't have a cleaver. I should get a cleaver.
Yeah! Leave it to cleaver.
Do you have a cleaver? Leave it to cleaver. Do you have a cleaver I can borrow? We could guest star your cleaver for Halloween.
I feel like I need a fucking axe. Just...
And my axe! Oh, God.
Boy.
I dig it a lot.
This is not... the approved method.
It is nowhere near the approved method. We probably need a much bigger knife. Watch your thumb. Yep. Appropriate! Opa!
Ah! It worked.
It did work, thank God. Okay, so here, have a beer. I feel like you've earned it.
Do not try this at home.
Do not.
Even though
we're trying it at home.
Yeah, we are, but we're insane.
I felt very anxious. OBX Pirate. Yeah, that was fucking terrifying.
Oh, God. Wait, no. I can't. I don't think he should eat seeds.
Nope. Bad idea. Okay, so I'm going to get a small bowl, and we are going to scoop out the innards.
It's slippery.
It's slimy.
I can't get new purchase.
It's slimy.
All right. Okay. We're scooping out the innards.
We're scooping out the innards and putting them into this bowl. We are scooping them out with
Yes, the innard scoop.
Tips and tricks. Ice cream scoop.
Ice cream scoop. You know, I didn't even know that, but I was thinking, man, we should use an ice cream scoop for this.
Well, ta-da. I actually really like this ice cream scoop. I got it on Amazon. Okay.
Yeah, no, move that up completely. Okay. That should be nowhere near my bare arms.
Completely out of everywhere.
It's a terrible idea.
Everywhere possible. I'm just going to put this up here for now. I will also remove your... Yeah, I'm just going to take all of these.
Hey, look. It's October, and we have terrified our audience.
Perfect.
Doing our job.
We are doing our jobs.
Not our job, because...
You can set it on the cutting board and do it there, and then just empty it into the bowl.
Yeah, but this is way more satisfying.
That's fair. But yeah, so the ice cream scoop I got on Amazon, I have been on the hunt for like a solid ice cream scoop for probably years and have had zero fucking luck until this one. I don't remember what brand it is. I can probably go back in my Amazon cart and find it, and I will post it up on the Pole Chef Facebook group, which... For those of you who are not already a part of it, please go find us on Facebook. We also have a YouTube channel where this stream will end up for those of you who missed any part of the stream earlier.
Yeah.
See, that does a really fucking good job.
It really does.
It gets it nice and clean. I kind of, see, now I want to use an ice cream scoop to do pumpkin stuff.
Yeah.
I feel like if you get something with like a pointy enough like tip on it, you can get like all the
tune in a couple weeks when we do pumpkin stuff.
We're going to do pumpkin shit. Cinnamon, nutmeg, cloves, pumpkin everything.
We should definitely do a pumpkin carving episode.
I mean, I need to fill my time. Yeah. Anyway.
Hey, you guys want to see, like, an extra...
Special episode.
Yeah, like a pumpkin carving thing.
Yeah, happy first of Spoopoween to everybody.
Spooptober!
Spooptober! Yeah, no, so in addition to needing 50 followers, I also need to stream a certain number of days in a month and a certain number of hours. So I've been trying to come up with like special episodes that I can do for you guys. So if you guys have ideas for like quick and dirty things that I can do on the internet, let me know. That involve food. No, I tried to make it better as I went and it just got worse. So if you guys want to see a special Pole Chef episode on anything in particular.
If you like them quick and dirty, slow and dirty.
Mostly dirty.
Just not clean.
As long as it's not clean, we'll do it.
It's not part of the brand.
Exactly. It's very off-brand.
Very
clean
off-brand.
Is off-brand for
clean
us.
Clean is off-brand.
Yeah.
Unless it's our hands before we prepare meat.
Those are always clean.
Always.
Always clean.
We never screw that up.
Rule 34.
Never.
Absolutely. Especially in our kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like...
I'm just all up in these squash's guts.
You're like baby pumpkins.
Yeah.
I did do some pumpkin carving recently. That was a lot of fun. I definitely think that since we just moved to this neighborhood, I'm not quite sure how into Halloween our neighbors get.
I really hope
they get really into fucking Halloween.
I don't know. I have a feeling that they're going to be like really into it.
I really hope so. Because it would be a real shame.
We have a perfect setup for a Halloween thing.
Yeah, we do. We
Jesus
got...
Christ, we might actually get like trick-or-treaters.
Oh, fuck.
We have to like...
We should get candy. And like, wait, we could dress up as stuff. Okay, Pole Chef Pole. I want to dress up in costume to meet trick-or-treaters. What should we dress up as to freak out our neighbor kids? That's what I want to know.
We should absolutely not be taking advice from this audience.
I didn't say we were going to do it. I just want to know what they think we should do.
That's fair. I broke off a piece.
That's okay. All right.
I think
so,
I'm done.
Empty out the rest of the seeds into the thing, and we will sort and rinse and squish the innards in a moment.
Yeah, I bet you could totally...
Roast them?
Roast these seeds.
Yeah, I'm going to...
Just like pumpkin
I'm
going to
clean them off and rinse them off and then just toss them in like some oil. I actually... What did we learn?
I missed. They're so slippery.
I actually have pumpkin seed oil from a friend of mine who gave me just a fucking bottle of bougie pumpkin seed oil that I've never used on anything except for like sweet potatoes one time. So I'd be really excited to see what happens with that. You can...
I don't know what I'm doing.
You can just leave them here for now.
All right.
All we're going to do is lube, season... and place these. The oven sounds like it's preheated, so we can start sticking these in the oven.
Cool.
And then we're going to go to stove cam and make sauce. Actually, we should prep the onion first before we do that.
Yeah. We're not done prepping.
Right. There's so much prep for this.
Pumpkin chili.
Ooh.
Lasagna, that sounds amazing.
Oh my god, that sounds good. Sarah Edwin thinks we should dress up as Vikings.
Jump scare in the courtyard from Filament Buster, who I haven't seen around yet. Cool.
Filament Buster. Hi. Don't know about costume, but you should definitely have a jump scare in the courtyard. Fuck yeah. Mm. I think that's a great idea. Kitchen accident victims. That's great. Oh, shit, yeah. Okay.
All right.
So.
We're going to make an onion.
Yes. Onion is on the counter over there. While you are prepping that, you need your knife.
Are we done with the garlic? We need more garlic.
Yes, we'll need garlic because we got to put some in the sauce.
All right.
While you are doing that, I'm going to go rinse these seeds off.
How do you want this done?
Minced. Yeah. Or like chopped, but like not like a garlic mince, but like.
Yeah.
Just okay. Chop it.
Small chops. Small dice.
Small dice.
Okay.
One more time, small dice.
I can do.
Okay, so while he does that, entertain our masses, I'm going to go clean some seeds.
Hey, potato.
To the sultry sounds of our sultry sound guy.
Sultry sound guy, Seth.
Hashtag sultry sound guy.
How many more S's can we fit into his title?
Maybe all of them. Love this like jazz lounge shit that's happening. Should we be taking instrumental song requests?
I don't know.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. We can get away with that, right?
Yeah, we totally can. We're covering.
So if we have
covering a song.
So
it's
fun
not,
fact,
it's
if we're instrumental covering a song, we can play it on Twitch. So if you guys have some piano songs that you want to hear, please let us know, and maybe our sound guy will grace him. Grace
strong
you guys
chance.
With his music.
Strong chance he can play it.
If he knows it.
Apologies if I don't. Even if he doesn't know it, just throw shit out there.
I'll learn it.
Right.
He'll fucking make something up.
I'll disappear for 5 minutes and then come back.
strikingly superior. I don't know what got sultry, smooth, sexy sound sorcerer set.
Whoa.
Jesus Christ,
whoa.
Larry.
Nice. Thanks.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Went deep into the bowels of Google for that
somebody,
one.
Somebody right clicked in
oh
Microsoft
my god.
Word.
Free bird. Hashtag not serious, please don't. You could do bird free, I suppose. What else we got? What else you guys got? Also, we're wanting to take questions from our viewers as well. So if
you
guys have
Freebird unless you say otherwise.
Right.
Quick. Somebody suggest something else.
We are going to play Freebird and only Freebird.
Burb Freedom.
Girl on Fire.
Okay, I need you to play Freebird, but the dumbest way possible.
Right, there you go. What have you done, OBX? Can he play Through the Fire and Flames?
That was a pretty dumb way to play Freebird.
Yeah, that was a very jaunty Freebird. Oh, BM Roland, you are right. He can, in fact, play Through the Fire and Flames. This is like ragtime Through the Fire and Flames. I really like it, actually.
More appropriate.
It is way more appropriate. We need stuff in a major key, preferably. Keep it light and happy.
No, it's actually.
I need a CD.
Why is this good?
Of Seth's covers. Please and thank you.
Oh!
Yeah! Big dick energy from our sound guy.
Oh, Stop making me laugh. I'm breathing in all this onion.
Oh, God.
Oh, shit.
Scenes from an Italian restaurant.
I've made onions.
Okay, you have made onions.
And it hurts.
Yep. Do you need to wash your eyes?
No, I'm good.
Okay. All right, so after onions, let me, there should be a bowl for, I did not give you a bowl for onions.
It's all right, I probably don't. No, I don't.
So hang on a second. That's not big enough.
I'm fine.
Are you sure?
This is serious onion.
This is fine?
This onion wasn't messing around.
This is not fine?
It's been through some shit.
Okay. All right, hang on. Trying to get our dish situation situated.
What you drinking? B.M. Roland. I am drinking mango wheat Blue Moon.
Fucking
it's
delish.
Fruity and delicious. Jesus.
Where? A bowl. Ask and you shall receive.
All right, thank you. Carry on.
Little mango. Blink faster, Steve. Behind the sofa?
That was goddamn beautiful, son.
That was
goddamn beautiful.
For a sound guy. Hell yeah.
Try and throw me again. That's how it happens.
Yeah. Yeah.
Subtext. You want to fucking go?
I'm weeping because of the
Where's
beautiful
Jesus
music,
behind the sofa?
Not because of the onions. I swear.
It was so beautiful. All right. So now that the onions are done, thoroughly, I would say get a paper towel and the vinegar mixture there and just wipe the onion shit off of the cutting board. Otherwise, it's going to follow you until you die.
What is happening?
This thing?
Mm-hmm.
Paper towel.
No, I'm good with the onion.
Okay.
I'll take onion over vinegar any day.
You committing your, committing to your choice? Okay, so now you're going to take the squash.
Squish,
and you're going to take that extra virgin olive oil.
Yo.
And you're going to lube it up.
Lube it up.
And then you're going to season it with salt and pepper, which I have over here.
Just the whole thing?
The whole thing.
Just get it all.
Just get it all, rub it all in the crevices. Get it all nice and lubricated.
All right. We're going to try this out. I'm just going to pour a little in the middle there. And then just get in there with the hands.
Get in there
really
with the hands. Get in there, Steve.
Get in there. Yep, I'm getting in. Just gonna make sure these. I keep wanting to call them melons.
I mean squash melons.
Yes.
Savory melons.
Squashes.
Squishing.
Ah, yeah. See, I can't do ground beef, but.
But you can do.
You want me to oil up?
Oil
up
a squishing.
I will do that for you. Oh. I'll get it all oiled. They're both fruit, technically.
Technically?
Really?
How does
this is a fruit?
I guess technically gourds are considered a fruit because they have the seeds on the inside or something? Nobody likes dry melons.
No, that's
seeds
on
the
inside.
Yeah.
Right.
Seeds on the I guess berries are a different thing, technically, because I know food stuff.
Ding, ding, ding.
And things.
Wait, berries are not fruit?
Berries and fruit are technically categorized as different things.
What?
Because like strawberries, blackberries, raspberries.
That's not a fruit?
Their seeds are on the outside.
Okay, my yogurt specifically says fruit on the bottom, and it has strawberries.
Your yogurt lied, Steve.
Bullshit. I refuse to believe that Yoplait lied to me. Okay, they've never told a fib in their lives.
No.
The most trustworthy company on earth.
Of course not.
I'm sure of it.
All right.
I feel like I'm not going to need moisturizer after this.
Probably not.
Skin is just glowing.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Like these squeeching.
Squeeching.
Which is now a new word. Hashtag squeeching.
Hashtag squeeching.
They also told you it was fat-free, I'm sure. No, they did not! Because I don't buy fat-free shit. Because if I'm gonna fucking eat something, I'm just gonna eat it. However it is, right?
Like Weird Al says.
Like diet soda? Ugh. Forget that. Diet soda is the worst.
Nasty. If you are one of those people who can't drink soda for medical reasons, don't get diet soda because you're diabetic. Don't drink soda.
No, but for real, don't
just,
do that.
Just really don't.
It's horrible. Diet soda is the worst shit on
earth. It's not worth it, I promise.
It's like literal poison. Don't drink it.
Berries on the Bottom. Yeah, Berries on the Bottom has a better ring to it.
Yeah, why didn't they just say that?
Just be truthful, Yoplait.
Right? Berries on the Bottom.
Why are you fronting?
Yeah. No, I don't really think Yoplait is at fault here. I'm going to go with the American education system.
You know what? I will not disagree.
Because, Lana.
Yes?
So, I would like to put salt and pepper on these.
Mm-hmm.
My hands are completely covered in olive oil, and I don't want to touch anything. So if you want to put the salt and pepper on there,
I can
continue rubbing it in front of all of these people on the internet.
Don't have to tell me twice.
Just keep rubbing and rubbing.
The whole, all of it?
So much rubbing.
Okay.
Sensually.
Did you get the insides?
Yeah. Right. No, I got
They're
it all.
Sufficiently lubricated.
They are freaking lubed.
Okay.
Spared no expense.
Spared no lube.
Spared no lube.
Hashtag spared no lube.
Knowledge is knowing tomato is a fruit.
Oh, yes.
Wisdom is knowing not to put it in a fruit salad. Philosophy is wondering if ketchup is a smoothie. Wow. Expletive, 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 rubbing gourds.
Yes, that seems appropriate.
Ah, now it's good and gritty.
Yeah, get that exfoliation on.
Yeah. God, this is...
an experience?
This whole meal is just very...
sensual?
Tactile.
Season the gourd.
Yeah.
Okay. So keep rubbing that in.
We are certainly not censoring you guys.
No,
so,
of course not.
You know, whoever is
holding
doing that,
down.
It's not us.
Yeah,
certainly
we're
not
most
us.
Definitely a curse-friendly stream. Let it all out.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I agree. All cooking should be tactile and sensory and... delicious.
Mm. Man.
All right, so when you're done lubing those up, you can...
I'm really working it in there.
Yep.
These squish are not going to have any knots. Very relaxed
really deep,
squish.
Deep tissue squish and massage.
Yep. Just really...
I guess, B.M. Roland, I don't know if it's an expletive because it all comes out
apparently it
stars.
Is. We don't know what it says because we can't tell.
Try using it as a hashtag instead.
Or use, like, characters, you know, like...
Leet speak?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that
bring,
gets around it,
bring
right?
that shit back.
I don't see any censoring.
Oh, interesting.
Interesting. We see censoring.
We see stars.
I see so many stars. Yep, that's all stars.
Yep, all fucking stars.
What the fuck?
Sensually is...
They're
censoring sensually.
They're censoring sensually.
Okay.
Yeah, say that five times fast.
No, I can't even say it once.
Censoring sensually. Censoring sensually. Censoring sensually. Censoring sensually.
Oh my god.
I can do it. Yay! Damn it, Twitch. Yes.
Damn it, Twitch.
Damn it to hell.
Shakes fist.
I mean, as long as you guys can see it, that's fine. I don't know why for us it's being... I don't know, maybe I accidentally put on some kind of parental filter when I set this up.
How dare!
Yeah.
That's fine. Okay, I think I got most of these seed buddies.
I was afraid Oliver might be watching. You know, he's underage.
He's... barely.
Alright, these have got to be about the best lubed... and the seasoned squash that ever existed.
Fantastic.
My hands are so gross.
These
hands.
These hands. Okay, so we'll tag out for a second.
Can I wash myself off?
You can wash yourself off. Go clean yourself off.
I will. there's a lot of stuff in the sink.
Do you need help?
I just don't want to, like...
You're fine.
All right.
Just don't get soap in the seed bowl. That's it.
I'll try.
Okay. So I am...
God damn.
Why is it always on all the way hot?
Why just...
Oh no, I lost my label. That's fine, I'll make a new one. I'm trying to figure out a good way to label these. These are also made by OXO. These are these like squeezy oil bottles.
Are they?
Yeah,
They're really good.
Fuck yeah. They have like a one hand easy close.
I dig them.
Pop tap. I like these a lot because they give you like precision control of how much oil you're using. So I'm just gonna drizzle this with a little bit more oil. Not a whole super duper lot because there's already a shit ton on the squash. I just don't want it to stick to the bottom of the pan. So I am face side down, like so, like meow. And then I'm gonna get the seeds and I'm gonna sprinkle them like all in between everything. Bonus points if you guys can guess the song that's playing.
Yeah, guess the song.
Let's play guess the song.
I know it, but I can't remember the words.
If you play Bioshock Infinite.
Yes.
Such
where
a good
are
damn
Bioshock
game.
Nerds?
Ugh. Yeah.
Fun, unrelated fact, those bottles are also great for dyeing fabrics and fiber. Ooh, that's good to know. Because they give you like that precision tip. But just the tip. Okay, I think that's good. There's some stringy bits left, but I'm not gonna be super upset about it because they'll just bake right off. All right, so we've got our seeds. Is this mine or yours?
That's mine.
You have the mango one.
Mango.
Can you refresh my beer?
Boy, can I.
Because I am out.
What would you like?
Surprise me.
You want mango?
Sure. So I put the seeds back in this bowl. I basically just separated them from all of the squashy, stringy bits. Just like you do with pumpkin seeds.
Not even close.
I'm not even remotely close. And I'm just pulling out some of the like squashy, fleshy bits and trying to separate the seeds as much as I can. So I'm gonna do seedception, and we're gonna do these in pumpkin seed oil. Because reasons.
Woo.
Yeah.
So we're just flying off our hip.
We are deviating from the fucking recipe.
Deviating from the recipe!
Oh god, yes! Yes, it's so appropriate! Alright. God, that's so good. I feel like, I don't know, somewhere between like American Psycho and a Batman episode.
It's Star Trek.
Yes. That's the fucking one.
Is original Star Trek sound effects.
OG.
That's what we needed to look up.
Yeah, right? We spent so long trying to find that fucking sound. We got through so many iterations of, like, alarms and sirens. And what was the thing you found? Like, danger?
Just danger.
Just danger. Yeah. Nothing else. Just danger. Oh, I saw an avocado. I saw an avocado.
Avocado! Invictus!
I really hope that you guys hear the avocado. Can you guys hear the sound that it made? Please tell me you did. Because it's really very important to everything that we're doing.
Yeah.
We worked very hard to find you that avocado.
Also, thank you for following.
No! It's not making the sound! It needs to make the sound!
No!
We'll work on that for next time.
I'll make it for it.
Yes!
That's the sound.
That's the sound. That whenever exactly you see the avocado, the imagine that sound.
That's exactly what's happening when the avocado is happening. Which...
Can we sample that?
I don't know.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Right, we'll get the avocado sound for next time, and we can just play it every time that they announce a follower if we can't get it to actually do it on the stream.
I can just do it off camera, and then it's as good as sampled.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Right?
Fantastic. All right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm just spreading the seeds out in between the squash squishing.
You really got to get the breath in there to make it sound that extra breathy. Creepy.
I haven't heard it enough.
Yeah, that's okay.
The
there you
yeah,
go.
Yeah, that's fucking on it. Okay, so we've got all of our seeds in our squash. Like so. We've got the seeds in between all the squishing. Salted, oiled, peppered, and the whole nine. Can you open the oven for me?
Yeah, I can actually do things.
Okay.
Whoosh. Right, this is a cooking show.
Yeah.
That's what you're watching, baby.
Okay.
A cooking show.
Woo. It's hot. Sorry. All right, so now we're going to set a timer for 40 minutes. Okay, so that's gonna go. I believe we all only have garlic for the sauce left because we did the onions.
Garlic for the sauce.
Garlic for the sauce is all that's left, and then we can go to stove cam.
This is the longest fucking prep section we've ever.
Oh done. Yeah, that's what we get for making meatballs from scratch.
An hour and 30 minutes.
That's like most of the stream is just prep.
Our sound guy is stretching.
Yeah.
It's that long.
Yeah. But, so the recipe says that the sauce is supposed to go for an hour.
You don't want that one.
No. No, I don't.
You want that one?
That one's good.
That one?
Yeah. That one. The other one.
Oh, that one's three.
Is it? Oh, sure. We'll do that one.
Which one do you want?
All of them.
All
three of them.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
I know what I said.
Okay. I just want y'all to understand. We have used an entire half of an elephant garlic head. Which is ridiculous.
OBX Pirate, does this feel like the appropriate amount of garlic to have used for an Italian dish? That's what I want to know. I feel like the answer is yes. BM Roland wants you to play Metallica.
Play Metallica, Seth.
Okay.
But
they didn't say what.
Anyone you want.
They didn't say what Metallica, just Metallica. Yes! Fuck yes. I love our friends.
All right. I don't have a knife.
Right.
Is there a knife for me?
Safety first. Ooh, this is a good choice. I approve of this choice. I know you didn't expect him to actually do it, but that's the perk of having this man play piano in the background for shits and giggles. Always room for more garlic, in my opinion.
Nothing else matters.
This is, in fact, the kind of elevator music I can get behind.
Right?
For sure. Mm. Like, you always end up listening to this, like, weird smooth jazz. Or, like, Muzak.
Muzak.
Fucking Muzak.
I hate when my muse ends in ack.
Ack.
Press, please. And a bucket to put this in. Yes.
I feel like we had smaller bowls available once.
We did. I don't know
where they went. Where they went. They've just been absconded with.
Elephant garlic is juicier.
Yeah, I agree. One rebel clove.
It's so excited to get in the bowl.
Yeah.
No, first you have to be squished and diced.
It's just like squirting out the
really
sides.
Really, a lot of juice. Yeah,
it really is. I don't know if that means if it's fresher or not, or if it's just larger so it holds more water than the smaller cloves do.
There's your. I've been drinking.
Yeah, that's perfect. Okay. Yeah, but it is definitely juicier.
All right, got a ooh fuck yes.
For me?
Yep.
I
assume that was.
Ooh fuck it. Does he know any Pat Benatar? Or the girl from Ipanema?
Oh shoot.
That's an actual tough one.
Yeah.
You have almost stumped our sound guy.
There's weird chords in there. I mean, I do know it, but I'm not comfortable busting it out at this very moment.
No pressure.
All the pressure. What are you talking about?
All the
pressure. Do it now!
God damn it!
I have not played that since high school jazz band.
Okay, so he just uttered the words high school jazz band.
Yes.
Was anybody else in jazz band? I know you guys are a bunch of fucking nerds as well. Who did weird shit in high school? Ipanema was in relation to elevator music, not a request. Oh, okay. That's super fair.
Thank God.
Super fair. However, do you know any Pat Benatar?
What songs?
Alternatively, we would accept Bat Penatar.
Is that like the Weird Al version?
Is that yours or mine?
That one's yours. Mine is over here.
Okay.
Okay, so we're done prepping.
Fuck.
So now we're going to go to Stove Cam, where the magic really happens.
Stove Cam! Wait, what? What I do isn't magic?
I mean, what you do is magic. But it is half the magic.
It's not magic. It's okay. I don't know what I'm doing.
So we're going to scooch this and position because we've got a couple burners to cover here. Okay.
How did we do this last time? We had more...
We had more oomph because I think we had it.
It was higher?
It was higher and further
back. Higher and further back.
We'll figure it out. Oop, Jesus.
I'll work on it. You cook things.
Okay. All right, it's close enough. All right, so.
Now we need the whole pole chef in the shot.
The whole chef?
Yeah, you do your thing, I'll figure this out.
Okay, so we've got our crispy, crunchy kale.
Crispy, crunchy.
Crispy, crunchy kale. So we're gonna set this aside. And we were gonna use this for the squash, but then I changed my mind, so this can go back where it goes. All right. So, first, we are going to do our sauce prep. This is, fun fact, the first time I have ever used this pot in my life. We got it as a wedding gift because I really wanted one, because Lodge is the tips, and I've never owned a Dutch oven before. And now we get to see how it makes a good fucking red sauce.
You've been married to Larry for all these years and you don't own a Dutch oven?
Nah! Not one I can use in my kitchen. Alright, so we're gonna heat this up. I'm gonna keep a burner going over here as well because I'm gonna need to move this out of the way. So, we're gonna heat this on like medium high. Yeah, I think that. Is that gonna stay?
No.
Precarious perch.
I think. Okay. Probably.
Here we go.
I'm totally not holding it now, and...
All right.
They can see the pot.
I mean, that'll work.
They can see the chef.
That'll work.
All right.
So we're gonna do this like between medium and medium high. And once it gets nice and hot, we're gonna put in the garlic and some oil and then the onions, and we're gonna sweat them all down a little bit. We're gonna add some tomato paste and all of the tomatoes and the seasonings. And then we're gonna mix them all up together, and then we're gonna bring it to a boil, bring it down to a simmer, and then let it simmer for the rest of the stream until we are ready to finish off everything. And then hopefully this will be done by the time the squash is done, so it all comes out at the same time, ideally. I'm gonna drink to that hopefulness.
It's for whoever asked for Pat Benatar.
Yes, BM Roland, we're playing Pat Benatar for you. Dig it. It is not like Creuset, it is Lodge, but they do make really good ones. Oh, no, it was Sarah Dwin. There you go. Also, Serena Scarborough Fair. Ah. VM Roland, I did theater costuming and lights in college. So, and I did choir in middle school. So I'm with you on all counts there, nerd friend. OBX played trombone. That's nerdy enough. I'll count that. Band geek. All right. Yep, there we go. We got Scarborough Fair going. I hear it. So we're gonna do a good solid. We're gonna bring these down. I don't know that we need lights. I can see what I'm doing.
Fuck lights.
Fuck lights.
Yeah, screw them.
Fuck them overhead lights.
Maybe no lights.
Too much glare.
Yeah, yeah.
All fill light all the time.
Who wants a fucking shiny forehead?
Exactly.
Nobody.
All right. I hear all that water. All right.
Yep, it looks way better without the overhead.
Yeah, it really does. We're experimenting Sweet. With the lighting in the kitchen to make sure that you guys can see all the food that we're cooking. And it was really glary last time, so we wanted to like futz with it a little bit and see what happens. Strings, violinist. Okay, yeah, I played violin for a hot minute in elementary school because my god sister did, and she was better at it than I was, so I stopped. Please don't fuck lights, it'll zap you. Don't tell me what to do in my own kitchen.
No kink shaming.
No kink shaming in my kitchen, damn it. Especially if it has to do with food. So since this is ceramic, it's going to take a minute to heat up, but once it does, we're going to do this, and und this, und
I gotta say, I wasn't sure about the apron thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really digging it.
Right? Isn't it great?
Yeah.
It is comfortable.
I especially like the bows.
Yeah. The bows are nice accents.
They're pretty, and the frills.
Yes.
I could use more frills in my...
In your cookware?
Mm.
Mm-hmm. Yes, BM Roland, you have no right to kink shame. Not especially not in my kitchen.
Mm.
Made the jump to choir in high school and college. Yep. Yep. No bubbles yet.
No bubbles.
Oop.
No bubbles.
I need bubbles. My bubbles.
No bubbles.
My bubbles. Shark bait. Ooh. Okay, I'm getting like little tiny bubbles.
Alright.
Little itty bitty bubbles.
They can't see the bubbles, but they're
There are bubbles happening, I
we
promise.
We can make frills happen. Really? Tell me more.
Oh shit, yeah. Okay.
God, that's a lot of garlic.
Right? So I'm just wooden spoon, big ceramic pot. Like, I'm trying to be as authentic as I fucking can here. Alright, so I'm just putting it in with some oil. I'm just doing it for like 30 seconds or so until it's fragrant. And then I'm gonna add in the onions, sweat them down, tomato paste, and then tomatoes. Can you grab the tomato cans?
Yeah.
And
where the hell are they?
They should be next to the sink.
Aha!
On the right. Careful.
Good God! What?
Yeah. So set one of those cans right there. On top. That. So one of the cool invention gadget kitchen things. One of the only kitchen gadgets that I really, really wholeheartedly get behind. It's like a cockroach for my hand. It's so cool. What is this sorcery? Go ahead and push the button again.
Oh, really? It's just gonna keep going?
Yeah, it'll keep going until you tell it to stop going. Go ahead and push the button. Alright, now, what you'll do, because this is a magnet, hold the hand still.
Holy shit.
Right? Go stick that in the sink. You can leave the can open because I'm just going to dump this straight into the pot.
What the hell just happened?
I just blew his mind. I love this fucking automatic can opener. I have been through several, and they have not been up to par, in my opinion. You can do the second can if you really want.
Oh, sweet Jesus, that smells good.
Oh, shit, yeah.
We got, fire roasted.
Fire roasted San Marzano tomatoes.
I don't know if you can read that.
This is, so we're doing Babish's recipe now, so hopefully I do him justice.
What we're doing?
Yeah, this is his red sauce recipe. So.
All right, justice to Mr. Ish.
Mr. Ish.
Mr. Bish.
And Andrew Rhea.
Is that who it is?
Andrew Rhea, okay. Yes, is binging with Babish.
All right.
Binging with Babish is like PoleChef.
Right.
That's the brand. Andrew Rhea is his name. He lives in
so it's
New York, I think?
With less sexual overtones and swearing.
No.
Oh.
Just as much sexual overtones as and swearing.
Well, great.
Absolutely.
Wait, what are we doing here then? This is not new content.
I don't know.
Yeah.
We're doing it in D.C., whereas he's doing it in New York. Though it would be really cool to have him down here. So
wouldn't
maybe
it?
We'll start with that pipe dream.
Yeah, right? Someday. Hey, buddy, you want to come hang out?
Right? Hey, Babish, come hang out in my kitchen.
All right. So I just push this button?
Yep. And it'll just hug the rim. So we're gonna sweat these down a little bit more. It's like a little cockroach.
I could watch it do this all day.
It's fascinating, isn't it?
Really is. I don't know what's happening, but I know at the end of it, I'm getting tomatoes.
Right? Thank you so much, Vaughn, for reminding everybody to please follow and support us. We are on the road to affiliation, and we are almost there. We're
on
so
that
close.
Road.
We're down that road. That trail that we blazed.
The road.
The road. The which road?
The road,
road to affiliation! Fuck yes. God, I love that button.
Oh, Jesus. I should have hit that button. It's gone around too many times.
I know. Wait. Do the... Hold it still. I don't think it went around enough.
No, it went around. No! I broke it.
You okay, didn't. You didn't break it.
No, it went all the way around twice. Look.
Okay.
See those little grooves?
Mm-hmm.
The grooves.
The grooves. You threw off the end. I'm sorry. You have thrown off the end. Don't do that.
It is not loose.
No. Let's try it again.
All right. Maybe I didn't do it right.
Just let it run.
Leave it to me to fuck this up. Like, I'm not one for kitchen gadgets a lot of the time.
Well, this is really
I'm
fucking cool.
I'm super skeptical of most of them, but this thing's pretty fucking cool. Beware the groove!
Beware the groove! Fun fact, BM Roland and anybody else who's interested in has ever watched Emperor's New Groove.
No. There's a sequel. Did you know that?
There is a sequel.
It's not horrible.
Kronk's New Groove?
Yes, Kronk's New Groove.
I didn't know that.
We watched it. It wasn't hateful.
We just found out.
Lucas,
like,
peace. What up?
Lucas!
What it is? So fun fact about Emperor's New Groove, the voice actor who plays the old guy that goes, beware the groove.
Yeah, it's called Kronk's New Groove.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's fine.
It's a sequel.
It's good. Like, it's not terrible.
It's a sequel.
You really, really love Emperor's New Groove. and you don't expect it to be Emperor's New Groove.
I didn't hate it.
And you expect it to be a sequel. Just some more content with characters that you love.
Sequely.
Then you'll enjoy it.
For a Disney straight to VHS sequel.
Yes.
Right.
It wasn't bad for a Disney straight to VHS
sequel.
All right. So,
okay.
The voice actor that plays that old guy is the same voice actor that voices Piglet from the original Winnie the Pooh.
That's
so
true.
Now whenever I watch that movie, all I can see is Piglet going, beware the groove, the groove.
Okay.
Great.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? I am adding...
Asks Lucas, PC.
PC. I am adding tomato paste to onions and garlic. We are making the base for our red sauce. We are making spaghetti squash and meatballs with roasted kale on the sides for tonight's dish.
I'm so hungry.
I know. It smells really fucking good, and we're not done
so
yet.
So good.
Okay.
So we've got these sweated down. We've got the tomato paste in here. I'm going to go ahead and kick the fan on low.
Sweat.
Just to get some of the steam out of the way. But now comes one of my favorite parts. I'm dumping in the tomatoes. Because I just like the slop.
Oh, yeah.
God, yeah, that's sad. Yes. And one more. Uno más.
Yep. I'm really happy we decided to make the sauce.
Yeah.
Oh, I got some on my hand. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Can you...
That's a delicious splash.
Dispose of...
Yeah, I suppose I could actually help.
I suppose. Delish. All right, so I'm just going to mix these. And I'm going to bring this up to a boil. I'm going to put some seasoning in it.
Good.
Right. And we're gonna, like, if you see any, like, big tomato chunks, you can either leave them in or you can, like, crush them against the side, which is also why I'm using a wooden spoon so that it's sturdy enough to crush these, like, big ass tomato chunks so it all breaks down. All right. So here's our sauce.
Yep.
We're gonna add in a little bit of crushed red pepper flakes.
Yeah. Be careful, though. There's not like a dispenser
on this.
Top.
There's no cap
on
this.
You don't want to just dump the whole thing in there. I swear I never did that.
Into an entire vat of pasta. So I'm just going to give it like a light dusting because this is a lot of fucking sauce. And we don't want it to be too fucking spicy.
No, that looks perfect.
You could also add in red pepper flakes in with the onions and garlic as well if you want a more like...
Ooh, to like actually like cook it
mm-hmm.
in there.
Mm-hmm. To like roast it in a little bit.
Roasted red pepper flakes.
Roasted red pepper flakes.
I like every word in that sentence.
Everything that you said just sounds great.
Ugh.
We're also going to do dried oregano.
Oregano. Oregano, which is delicious. Unlike parsley, which is...
The devil spice.
Fucking Satan's herb.
Satan's herb.
Okay.
Herb. Steve has a real, like, whatever the opposite of a hard-on is for parsley, a flaccid.
A hard-off?
A hard-off, I guess.
I am.
It's
a
no-go.
It's a hard no.
A hard no. Hard limit.
Mm-hmm.
Parsley is a hard limit.
Parsley is my safe word.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. I personally love parsley.
I'm rolling. I appreciate your opinion and the fact that it is wrong.
In the words of Steve, you're allowed to be wrong.
See, I feel the way about parsley the way most people who don't like cilantro feel about cilantro.
Right. With cilantro, it's like a genetic thing.
Except
where they think
taste
it tastes
like
soap. You just hate it.
Right, no, it doesn't taste like soap. It just tastes like the, like... I don't know. Corruption of all that is good in food.
Okay, so the next bit, yep, so some leaves are already on their way over there. So we've got basically a whole bunch of basil, and it's just all gonna go in there. Exactly like this.
Oh.
Yeah.
We're just...
Surprise.
All right.
Just going in there. It is, in this instance, it is going to be considered an aromatic.
Mm.
So it is going in there, and it will be taken out later, which feels wrong to me, but I'm going to do it because that's the recipe. I've already deviated a whole fucking bunch today, so I think I'm going to simmer down.
Hey, piano man.
What's up?
You got a request.
For what?
Do you know any Pink?
That might be a no.
No.
No?
Nah, not this time.
Can you name one of her songs?
Glitter in the Air?
Nah.
How about, well, look, we'll just make it easy for you. We'll just throw a Floyd on the end of it.
There you go.
That I can do.
There you go.
There we go. All right, so we don't have Pink, but we do have Pink Floyd.
Yeah, there you go. Close enough.
All right,
right?
So
yeah,
those
are very
up.
Close musical substitutes.
I think so.
This other burner.
Exact same.
Look,
thing
if they didn't want to be considered in the same group, then they shouldn't have named themselves so close.
So what we're doing with this one is we are leaving it partially covered. And I'm turning this up because the pot itself is already hot. We're just waiting for the bottom heat element to heat up. But I'm going to heat this up until I see bubbles. And then I'm going to leave it, like, mostly covered. And we're going to let that sit for, like, till the end of the stream. We don't really have time to let it go the full hour this time, so it'll be a little more bright little more clean than some spaghetti sauces will be. But in the meantime, we're gonna sear some meat.
Sear that meat.
Sear the shit out of that meat. Cool. Cheers.
I'm out of beer.
Oh, well, you should fix that.
I should. I'm also gonna tilt this up slightly.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe back on. How did we have it?
I don't know. It was right there.
It was. I don't want to cut off the top of your head.
No, no, not the top of my head.
Okay. That seems mostly good.
Yeah, that's fine. All right, so for the meatballs.
Meat the ball.
Meat the ball.
Oh, I stabbed it.
No, no.
Woo, woo.
Our meatballs are Plate-O meatballs, which have been stuffed with a ball of fresh mozzarella. Look at our meat. Look at our meat.
So much meat.
All right, so for the meatballs, we are going to sear them first in small batches and set them aside. And then once the sauce is almost done cooking, we're gonna put all of the meatballs in with the sauce to finish cooking for the last like 10 minutes or so. So set those down.
Right.
I'm gonna heat up this pan. Actually turn it on, might help. And for these, I'm actually gonna use a Mediterranean blend a la Costco, which is, I believe, avocado oil, olive oil, canola oil, and grapeseed oil, question mark? Maybe not avocado oil, but it's like grapeseed and olive oil and vegetable oil. It's a blend of oils that are supposed to balance out the, Steve's gonna drop the meat. Steve, how much did this, the meat run us? This was a three pound tube of ground beef from the grocery store.
About $40.
About $40 for just the meat?
Oh no, the meat was like 10.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, the oil. Well, while I'm waiting for this pan to heat up, see if I can fish this bitch out. Mm. Oh yeah, I can just look at the fucking label.
That is a giant
Kirkland!
Jesus.
Fucking Costco. So this is canola, olive, and grapeseed oil.
That was a giant.
So this was like $20? $25? Something like that?
I thought canola oil was like the devil.
Canola oil is not the devil. The problem is that people use it too often for the wrong things and in too high a quantity. Canola oil is made from corn, which it breaks down into sugars and stuff, and people who are like health crazy get like all uppity about it. But there's really nothing fucking wrong with canola oil. It is a vegetable oil, which has a higher smoke point, so you can use it for things like steaks. If you're frying anything with breading in a pan like this, use vegetable oil because it has a high smoke point. And that's what we're gonna do because we wanna sear these balls.
Sear.
Sear the fuck out of them balls.
Remind me to never make you angry.
All right, so I'm gonna get a good sheen on here. Fingers crossed. So, test it. Yeah! That's the sound I want.
Sizzle, sizzle.
So I'm gonna put these in flat, and I'm gonna go clockwise.
Oh, is that the little one just for me?
Yeah. Actually, here's the little
one. Oh, that's a really little one. That one's mostly cheese.
This is mostly cheese.
Mostly cheese.
Mostly cheese. So I'm giving these guys a little bit of space. Or I'm trying to anyway. That way they get a good sear on them. If you crown them too much, just like with the kale, they will wilt and they will boil and steam instead of sear. And I want some like good dark brown color on this shit. Not fucking around with my meatballs today.
Wait. I can't see a problem. No, no. Damn it. Meat cooking.
Yeah.
But they can also see
the people.
The chef cooking the meat. There we go. Okay.
There we go. That's better. Bam! Bam! Alright. I'm gonna need my tongs.
Hey, piano man.
Yeah?
You know any Cisco?
Cisco? Is that a band or a...
Oh, God. Band? Are you not familiar with the tong song?
Elaborate.
Oh, man. Okay, so we'll have to educate our sound guy on Cisco.
That's like a brand of hot sauce, right?
No. Cisco? No, that's Crisco.
Yeah. My bad.
No.
No, it's
also like a bank, isn't it?
Gotta bring that out of the
room. No, that's Citgo.
That's a gas station.
Oh yeah. Cisco is a router.
A router? Oh.
Fucking nerds.
Blue Oyster Cult, we have a request.
Blue Oyster Cult, don't fear the Reaper.
The cult of Blue Oysters. I'm pretty sure we have a sound bite for that, actually.
Probably.
I mean, close. In the ballpark.
And you can feel free to play a little bit louder, too, because we've got a lot of sizzling happening.
That's true. You guys let us know if you can't hear something, or because the sizzling is quite loud, at least from our vantage point.
Mm-hmm. Cisco is for plasticware. All right, so we are going to need to clear off that other plate?
Okay.
Yes. So then we can get it cooked.
Cleared.
Blurred.
This garlic taking up all this space.
So much space.
So much garlic.
That feels like the requisite amount of garlic.
Cheers, Vivictus.
Oh, Vivictus, what up?
Dance and roll. Yeah.
Piano Man.
What is the most spiteful rendition of Piano Man that you know? That's what I want to hear.
You really want me to show spite towards one of your
viewers? Spiteful Piano Man? Yes,
we
exactly
do want
you
to spite our viewer.
Yes.
All right, let me finish this.
It's a love-hate relationship.
So
understand.
I'm only taking these off for a hot second because there's a lot of liquid happening in this pan. And I want there to be less liquid.
Too much liquid.
Too much liquid. I don't want to boil these balls.
I think those look good as they are.
I believe you.
Nice and pink, barely cooked. That's how you want your ground beef,
that's
right?
That's exactly how you want your beef. Can I have you drain this in the sink?
Oh, you too, BM Roland.
Can you drain this in the sink for me?
Oh, shit.
Just tilt it out a little bit. Down the side or whatever. Yeah, like not directly in the...
How much do you want going?
Most of it.
Like when?
That's good. I just want like a little bit coating the bottom. I want some sear on these bitches. No boiled meat in my kitchen. Because as the beef cooks down, kind of like bacon, it will also start to release juices.
Them juices.
There we go. I'm really feeling the spite. Can you wash that with hot water and soap?
Probably.
Okay. All right. And we do have some bubbles on our sauce, so I'm going to give this a stir. And bring it down to a simmer. Don't forget, did I add salt and pepper? main ingredients.
Okay.
Salt.
What?
I misplaced the salt.
Oh.
I'm just gonna put a little bit in because I'll salt it towards the end as well, but I've got a little bit of something.
Simmer down, which is precisely what we're doing with the sauce.
Precisely. Do you wanna come smell this real quick?
Oh, you're right. Delicious! Yeah.
we need to spatula.
Spatula.
A spatula.
Mostly, just to get these meatballs off the bottom of the pot without breaking them. Just to kind of loosen the bottom a little.
I gotta be honest. I'm kind of excited for these meatballs.
Yeah?
Like, I'm
legitimately
like
actually excited for
meatballs. I don't like meatballs.
Right. But
never
have. These are getting me a little bit excited. I will take that compliment.
California is a Yelp review with a 3-minute guitar solo. What's happening?
Where's the other mitt?
What do you need?
I need the other mitt.
You need mitts?
I need one more mitt.
Oh,
it's under the garlic.
Well, oh.
But it doesn't have to be the matching mitt.
It's fine. No, it must match.
It must match.
We're on TV.
Love me.
You've been gloved.
Okay. Woo! Yeah, that hit me right in the face. Okay. Our roasted squash in and seeds in.
Bam!
Alright. These are gonna go right now. The cool
oh off. Shit, you roasted the seeds too.
Yeah, we did. Just set those aside for now. Alright, so these, I just want to make sure I get it at least brown on most, if not all sides.
Oh, the sound guy's taking a bathroom break.
Wait, is someone asking for me?
No.
No, it's cool. I got it, man. I got this covered. Hang on. God.
Steve's taking over the piano. How do you
do
it? Don't worry, I got this. Wait, what is this button?
This job doesn't seem too hard, man.
What are you trying to do?
I'm a musician. It's beautiful.
I'm about everything that's happening right now.
That goat apparently does not approve of my play.
The goat does not approve.
That's great content for the viewers.
Right?
Yeah,
this is exactly what our viewers want. Alright. Last ones. And then, once we're done with these, we will check our sauce, and then we'll go on to shredding the squash.
Shredding squash.
For the time being, these are the mostly finished meatballs. We're gonna stick these into the sauce close to the end of the stream, which will be very soon. Stop it, Steve, don't scare away our viewers. Have some faith. Have you no faith? I shake my tongues at you.
Shake.
I mean, it's not as good as a wooden spoon, but that's covered in sauce. So, I don't want to get that.
I'm clearly here to chop things, not make music.
Your knife is your instrument.
Ah, yes.
So profound. Thank you, Blue Moon.
The last four meatballs.
The last four meatballs.
The final meatballs!
Okay. Yeah, that happened.
We're actually, still doing something. Right.
Right. This is, for anybody who's curious, this is literally how we are when we make food at home normally. It's just there's a camera here this time, and we talk to each other instead of at nobody. Or a webcam. So, the shit that we come up with jokes-wise, this shit happens every goddamn day. That mitt needs some googly eyes. I would love to get some googly eyes for my oven mitt.
Good idea.
I think that would give it some character. That is what makes a good meatball.
What?
That brown sear.
Yeah.
If you just boil meatballs, they're...
Wait, boil? Who the fuck boils a meatball?
Heathens, and not the kind I like. If you steam or boil or crowd your meatballs, if you don't give them a good sear first,
mm-hmm.
or if you just God forbid, have frozen meatballs. Exactly. They will get...
Is this
get,
why I hate meatballs?
Probably. It's probably the same reason that we all used to hate Brussels sprouts as a kid. B.M. Roland's parents. B.M. Roland's parents boil meatballs. They boil frozen meat... No! No! Incorrect!
I'm sorry, are you an orphan?
That's horrific!
Do you want to be?
That's... No! Bad parents. Bad.
I'm sure your parents are lovely.
I'm sure they're fine. Fine parents.
Wrong. Where's
so,
that gif of Steve Carell just screaming?
No!
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 No, God, no!
I
they
don't
are
know.
Not fine.
Can I adopt you? I don't know.
Legally? I have no clue.
Maybe.
I haven't looked into it lately.
How much will the state give me for taking care of you?
I don't know. Couple hundred a month, maybe?
I
don't know how much kids are worth these days. I haven't peddled in children in so long.
Roland, how much do you eat?
Right.
Yeah, if I
can
just...
We eat a lot in this house, so
right.
If you have a big appetite, I don't know how we might be able to feed you.
I don't know.
It might not work out so well.
I mean, it's not like we run a cooking show or anything.
No, of course not.
We have no idea what we're doing.
None whatsoever.
I have no idea what's even happening right now. I mean, there's meat and an oil, and it's sitting all over the place.
But yeah, so if you boil, or steam, ground beef this in a meatball, it'll all be this not the darker brown bits, but that grayish brown bit in the middle.
Yeah.
All of it, all the way through, and it'll be mushy and no flavor. It's gross.
That sounds like most meatballs I've ever had.
Yeah, that probably means. What about the meatballs at IKEA?
Gross.
Have you ever had them?
Yes.
That's why you hate meatballs.
Didn't like them.
That's why you hate meatballs.
Thought they were crap.
Yep, that's why you hate
Everybody
meatballs.
Talks about how great they are, though. Everybody talks about how great they are.
The thing about Swedish meatballs is we don't run a profitable cooking show. Exactly.
Someday.
The thing about the Swedish meatballs from IKEA is that those meatballs are frozen and probably boiled of some kind, so they're very gray and mushy. If you make meatballs with a good sear on them first and then use the Swedish meatball sauce, it's different. The texture of the meatball makes or breaks it, hands down. Alright, so these meatballs are seared enough for my liking, so I'm going to turn these off. Stop moving. The cabinet got freshly too. Break them free.
I want to break free.
All right. Please dump all of this out and then hand me back the pan. It's very warm to be here.
Not supposed to dump this stuff down the sink.
I think there's a rule about it, but you know.
I'm just gonna run some water.
That's fair. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to not balsamic. Red wine vinegar.
I'm sorry, did you say grape jelly and chili sauce?
You know, actually, isn't that how Scotty makes them?
Who?
Scotty makes the meatballs for all of the, like, dinners and stuff.
Grape jelly?
Yeah, grape jelly. And frozen in a bag meatballs in a crock pot. The meatballs that everybody loves so much at, like, all the Super Bowl parties and shit.
Wait,
that's exactly what that is. Deglaze now, which is one of my favorite things to do ever. We're going to do a mixture of water and vinegar. I'm going to do them both at the same time so that I don't burn it all. I turned the heat off, but the pan is still very hot. So, we're going to do like a little bit of vinegar and mostly water. Woo! Yeah!
I am currently running soap and hot water down the drain.
Yes.
Thank you for the recommendation, OBX.
Thank you. You ask of me? So I am, I'm gonna turn the heat up a little bit.
I never liked your meatballs.
How dare you question my meatballs, Steve?
I've questioned everything we've ever done for the last 25 years. I don't know why now would be a surprise.
I don't know why we need to start now.
Actually, to be fair, I've never had any.
For shame.
My spinach puffs!
My spinach puffs! I never liked your spinach puffs. Never! Alright.
You know what? I guess I'll have to try the meatballs next time.
Yeah.
I usually don't even give them a chance.
Yeah. Alright. So, continuing on, we are going to take this deglazed fond from our meat that is now no longer sticking to the bottom of our pan. There's some water and vinegar, and it's gonna go into the sauce, and it's gonna add a little bit more liquid and a little bit more tang to the sauce as it cooks down. It's not really gonna matter much at all, so I don't have to worry about its effects. But we're basically bringing the meat flavor into the sauce.
Yes.
Before we add the meat itself.
Meat flavored sauce.
Yes. Okay. That can go away.
And we're done with this?
We're done with that.
No more of this.
No more of this. And I'm just going to stir
I smell vinegar.
Yeah. It's because it was red wine vinegar.
No.
And water that I used to deglaze. Alright. So I'm just stirring that fond water into the sauce, and I'm gonna cover it back up again. Now we're gonna go back to the prep cart briefly for the squash.
Oh.
Yep.
More prep cart.
So we are going to go over to the cart. All right. This will be really interesting.
Okay.
Actually, it's you. None of these are want, or we can use the tongs.
Okay, what are we actually doing here?
We are, first of all, flip those over.
Okay.
And then we're going to take the fork, so now they're all soft and soggy. Whew. Don't hold it up, just like flip it over on the, yeah.
Got it.
So you're going to try and hold it steady.
Don't try to hold the hot squash that's covered in oil.
Hot squash.
It's going to slip.
You're going to take this fork and shred the inside.
Oh.
And you see how it like comes out all stringy?
I do see that.
Do that the whole thing.
Oh, man.
We're not going to eat the skin, so we just want to shred as much of the insides as we can get out of it.
Okay. Fuck yeah. This is a lot of work.
Yeah, it is. It's going to be fucking worth it, though. It's going to be legit as fuck.
Oh, yeah, it's just coming right off there.
Yeah, it's really soft.
Like butter.
Like butter.
Butter.
Like butter. Yeah, spaghetti squash is very watery, so you have to be... Yeah, like the rind is really just...
Yeah, no, it's like rock hard.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna get a bowl for the nudes.
Yeah.
Put a bowl for the nudes. I might need a bigger bowl. No, I think I'll be fine. Man. It is fascinating to me how gourds work. Like, the rind is extremely tough because I would always be afraid of, like, poking a hole through. Like, when you try to scrape out stuff from a potato.
Yeah.
You know? I'm always afraid that the fork is going to, like, poke through the rind.
Sure.
But not the case here.
Mm-mm. You guys actually see what's going on here? I don't know what
My
you just said,
Roland. BM Roland, you got censored.
You got censored.
I don't know. Give it to me in hashtags.
Shit.
Or elite speak.
Everything is really hot.
Mm.
It is burning my goddamn hands.
Careful.
Don't die.
Thing in my throat.
Mm.
Not welcome.
All right,
that can go.
How's
in
that
the
look?
Perfect. That is a clean ass skin.
Woo-hoo. Right.
So that is like completely cleaned out.
Clean.
Floppy, and that can go directly in the food garbage.
Send nudes.
Yes.
LS Gaming, that did not come through either.
We're really gonna have to figure this out. Do you
yeah.
want me to do that?
Do what?
Richard, do what?
Do what?
Do what?
Do what?
What you're doing? Try doing it long ways and see if the textures. Yeah, I mean, it'll the same thing. I'm just curious.
Okay.
To see if we get like longer stringies or if it doesn't matter.
No.
Nope, do it the other way.
Yeah.
And it just comes out as mush.
Yep. It's already a little mushy.
So, fun fact, when you get spaghetti squash, make sure to do it short ways across, not like long ways up and down. That way you can maintain the stringiness of the spaghetti squash strings.
I'm gonna try and use less strokes to get the same job done.
Okay.
Maybe have more nudes.
Definite phrasing. Are we not doing phrasing anymore? Careful, don't get the skin. There you go.
Alright, it's gonna be a little squishy, I think.
Yep. Took me entirely too long to get that. I feel ashamed. Two more. We are halfway done.
Woo! We can do this.
And then as soon as these are done, we can check the sauce.
Oh yeah, this one's coming out.
Oh
great.
Yeah, that one's really stringy.
Yeah. I think it was just that particular squash.
That one specific squash.
Yeah, I don't really want to
separate.
Not the right way.
Gotta keep them separated.
Hey.
Yeah, there were oil and salt and pepper.
Well, try it.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
Fuck yes.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Those are so good. Okay. The rest of the stream is just going to be us eating these fucking amazing.
All right, so fun fact, spaghetti squash seeds roast just the fuck as well
Holy
as pumpkin seeds.
Holy crap. Okay, hang on. Seth.
Yeah, you have an option.
You gotta fucking try this.
Put that in your mouth.
Oh my God. Oh my, I know. Oh my God, this is a, just eat the whole thing.
It's
just
the,
eat the whole thing.
Just put it in your mouth.
Don't ask questions, just chew it up.
Right? Right?
It's, oh man.
It's seeds.
Are those the
seeds?
Yeah.
There's the seeds from the pumpkin squash or the
oh,
spaghetti
yeah.
squash.
Oh my God.
Right?
I know.
Shit, yeah.
Please.
Yeah,
okay.
come grab. Screw the sound.
We're not going to eat them all because we still need
no.
I want to use these
this
as a garnish.
Everybody.
I want to use this as a garnish. Here's our sound guy.
Mm.
Our sexy,
oh
sultry
God.
Sound guy.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, finish the squash so that we can put these on
Shit,
more
I'm
of our food.
Shit, I'm doing stuff.
I've given up my post because these are too good. Because
these are just too fucking good. Damn, those turned out really
good. Was that just
good,
like incidental that...
Yeah.
Yeah, so like I forgot that they had, like I knew they had insides, but I forgot they also had seeds like pumpkins. So
mm-hmm.
I was like, well I wonder if we take out the seeds and roast them like you do with pumpkin seeds, if they'll taste just as good.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever had like fresh roasted seeds
oh,
before.
Oh God, they're good.
Fucking tits.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, Chad. This is the man behind the piano and all of your ridiculous
you
requests.
From
Hashtag
karaoke.
Put it in your mouth. OBX Pirate. Oh, yeah.
Mm.
From back when.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Calypso.
Yeah, Calypso's karaoke.
Nice to see you again.
Sort of.
Nice to see your username on the internet.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound stalkery at all.
I mean,
do you come here often? Every Tuesday night.
At least it's not chat roulette.
Also, oh, God. That fucking black hole.
I'm less concerned about getting seeds involved in this anymore.
Yeah, yeah, no, don't worry about whether or not there are seeds, because there will end up being seeds. It's going to be a very seedy dish.
The seedy underbelly of PoleChef. I just got back.
I realized it wasn't done yet.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so that's done. We're going to get the... Last little stragglers here.
Yeah,
it's
last
got
little
skin on it, so that can go. Mm-hmm.
Last little straggling seeds.
Oh, can you stick this in
the
trash?
That's got like...
What am I
throwing away? Skin. Okay. Oh, God.
Why are these so fucking good? Right? Okay, so we're going to set these aside.
Mm.
And I'm going to add a little bit of salt and pepper to the squash.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to fucking check the sauce.
Oh, man. All right, I'm gonna collect up all these seeds and put them somewhere else.
In a container of some sort.
Yep. All right. Get back to work.
Get back to work.
You're gonna all
right.
have to feed me seeds all the time.
All the time, now, right? Shit.
Look, it's fucking.
It's form of
it is October, and
it is time.
This is the time for gourds, man.
So I am putting in the meatballs into the sauce. I know you guys can't see it, but I'm just going to narrate it because I don't want to have to move the camera again. I'm just putting all the meatballs into the sauce gently, and I'm going to crank the heat a little bit to help cook them, and I'm going to fully cover the pot this time. And we're going to give it about maybe 10 minutes, a little bit less, because these actually cooked a little further in the sear process than I originally meant to, but that's fine. I'd rather them cook too much than not enough. Because raw meat is no joke.
I need a bowl. Some sort.
You can wash out an existing bowl.
Sounds like work.
Sounds like work with extra
steps. I've been working
how dare.
So long.
How dare.
All day.
What do you need a bowl for? Seeds?
Yeah. I mean, look, I could just eat them all if you wanted.
No! They're really good and I want to use them as garnish now.
They're basically just salt and charcoal.
Yeah, which is perfect.
There's probably no nutritional value here.
None whatsoever.
But God, are they good.
Absolutely none.
Oh. No. Did you guys come here to watch us, like, eat stuff and fawn over things?
Basically.
Because if so, we can provide that.
We can indeed.
Oh my God. That's a huge bowl.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Alright, seeds go in there.
Seeds go in there. Okay, that wasn't completely terrible.
No, that was actually pretty good. Do you still need the fork?
Yeah. Yeet.
Yeet.
That was such a good idea, Lana. That's why you're the pole chef.
I have my moments.
That's why she's the pole chef.
Why I'm the pole chef, so I'm just gonna add like a...
No. They don't need more salt.
They do need a little bit of
no,
salt.
No, they're so salty. Taste them.
I did.
They're really salty.
It's like a little pinch.
Shan't I not question the pole chef's methods?
I just like the flake texture on the outside of the seed. Mm-hmm. Mush. Roasted flesh.
Where did my beer go?
Oh, where is the beer of mine gone?
Found it.
Huzzah. Okay. So we have kale, we have seeds. I am turning these meatballs in sauce.
She's turning the meatballs in sauce.
Some good stuff. All right. So now we're going to cover the meatballs and let them cook for a couple minutes. Then it'll be fucking presentation time, y'all.
Are we getting there?
Yeah.
I got a huge plate of greens and irresistible seeds.
Turn off the oven. That is how almost done we are.
Whew. All right.
I do need another beer though.
Boy, let me tell you, you guys have stuck around for the last
two and a half hours.
Near 3 hours.
Almost, yeah. We're at 2 hours 40 now.
And it'll be 3 hours.
Jesus Christ, guys. And we're still, like, at a decent number of viewers right now.
Yep.
You guys are fucking troopers.
You guys have been hanging out this whole time. We really appreciate it.
You guys are legit.
God. Had a blast tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this was a lot of fun.
What else are we doing?
Waiting on sauce.
That's it?
Yeah.
Just
that's all we have left.
We have nothing to do but wait.
We can season the squash if you want. That'll take all of 2 seconds.
Yeah. Wow.
So let's do questions and stuff. For those of you who are still with us, do you guys have any questions about like cooking techniques, recipes, ingredients, anything that you want to know about kitchen and kitchen related things? Ask us, give us things to talk about for the next couple of minutes while these meatballs finish off.
I just want to
share that golden goodness with these people. Bless the people.
I want you to see these. Wait, there we go. These seeds. My God.
My God, these seeds.
So delicious. Mm.
Shit, yeah. Of course, we'll save some seeds for you, obviously.
Maybe. There is no way we can promise that.
Mm. Obviously, maybe.
I don't know if these seeds are going to make it to the end of this show.
They will. I'm only having like one or two at a time. They'll be enough. Mm-hmm. I just need enough for garnish. Mm-hmm. I see the nudes. Oh, yeah, sure. Absolutely. Who am I to deny you the nudes? All right, so, can I have fork?
Yeah.
Scalpel?
Yep.
All right, so, spaghetti squash. Looking like a dis.
Yeah, that looks like spaghetti.
Mm-hmm. It's very short and stringy, so like...
Yeah, it's not like long noodles.
It's not like super long noodles, and some of them get like super duper tiny and short.
It does definitely.
But like it definitely
like
resembles
pasta.
Pasta.
Yeah. Is it pretty flavor neutral?
Yeah, it's So for this one, obviously we added like salt, pepper, and olive oil, so it's pretty standard flavoring, but like it tastes like a yellow squash almost, but it's a little bit sweeter. But yeah, pretty much. Tastes like squash. Yeah, like short angel hair pasta, basically. It's very, very thin noodles. Thin nudes. The only time you'll get those on this show.
What's sizzling?
Probably. Steam. It's still warm though, however, so I'm gonna leave it out until it cools down before I put it away. I'm gonna bring you guys over to stove cam while we stare intently at this sauce together. Oh god. Hang on. There's a better way this was before.
See if I can fix this.
There we go.
Problem we're having with.
Well, right now they just need like us.
Well, we're getting
directly in the chef's faces.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, what is that? Oh. Yep.
I'm turning off all the filters,
all the
guys.
Filters.
All the filters. Now we can see everything you're saying.
There we go.
Wait.
Try it again. Do it
Shit.
Again. Show message. Pervs,
pervs,
really? Was this message correctly hidden? No.
No.
No, it was not.
Do not hide pervs.
There's the other. Go.
Do not hide thick.
Definitely don't hide thick on my stream. Excuse
right.
you.
We want all the thick.
All the thickness.
2, 3, 4 C's.
Down with this thickness? No.
Oh, wait, no.
No, what?
Incorrect. No.
No, keep the nudes.
Keep.
Hashtag keep the nudes.
Nudes.
Damn, Twitch is a prude.
Okay. Let's see what this says.
Yeah, we're just going to go back and play. Let's filter. Let's unfilter all
yeah.
the good shit.
This totally makes good TV.
Hell yeah. This is super what our people want to see.
I missed it. I don't know.
That's fine.
All right.
Hashtag
I
keep the nudes.
The filters, so I think.
Perfect.
We should be good to go.
Hashtag no filter. Alright. So I'm gonna check on the sauce. I'm gonna bring you guys down to sauce level. This is really hot now, so we're gonna use a fucking thing. You see the boil on this bitch? Do you see the boil on this bitch? That is a sexy simmer. Look at all that.
taste the sauce. See what kind of seasoning I need.
Taste it.
It's very hot though. Toy Story.
I want to see you taste it. Yeah, there you go.
Shit, yeah. That tastes like a fucking marinara sauce. All right, I'm gonna add a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. Not too much. Pepper mill. But we're gonna do a little bit of salt, babe.
Ooh, ah, just a little bit. We're so close.
I can taste it.
We're right on the edge.
Literally.
I can taste it too. Mostly because I just keep eating these seeds.
So the last bit here is for us to try and fish out some of this basil, but I know some of this shit is not gonna make it. So where are my tongs? Though? I need your tongs. I need tongs or a fork.
Tongs.
Either one.
Here's a fork.
That'll work.
I can also get the tongs right in the sink.
That's fine. Really, I just want to get like the stems out. Literally any dirty dish.
What?
Any of those dishes, just like empty the water out and hand it in. That's
where these are going. What are those?
That's the basil stems.
Oh, it's trash.
Yep, so we're just trash. Fishing out like all the stems, because these are all the hard bits we don't really want to chew on.
You got a friend in me.
I like Toy Story, man. Makes me cry like a little bitch.
Me too. But I don't know all the words.
Some of us had lives, and then it was me. Well done, well done. All right, so I think we got all of the biggest pieces of basil.
For that, you get a
pieces.
Reward of more seeds.
More seeds! We'll make our sound guy play for seeds.
Keep playing Toy Story.
All right, so we've got all of the basil pieces out that are big enough to be a problem. The rest is done. So now, we're on to presentation, fellas.
Possible, presentation!
Presentation! Present! Food!
Sorry, it was reflex.
Yep, that one, down. Getting it, almost, okay, close enough.
Am I hiding underneath the table again?
Who knows?
Is it me?
You're looking for?
Or is it somebody else?
Potato! Ah! Sudden potato!
Ah!
Hell yes. Okay. So, now we're going to go on to plating. I need the white bowl from inside that cabinet. Carefully. It's right where the cabinet is. Thank you. So we're going to plate up in a bowl this time instead of a plate, because reasons. So.
Don't be confused. We're plating in a bowl.
In a bowl. All right.
Still plating.
So what we're going to do is we're going to do a bed of kale.
A nice bed of kale.
For
to lay its head on.
Because this is nice and crispy.
Mm.
I'm just going to grab like a fucking handful.
Yeah.
And I'm going to spread it out a little bit.
We've made so much food. The longest show ever.
I know, right? But so much goddamn food.
We could feed like 7 people.
Right.
Everybody watching.
But we're only watching 4.
Just come on over. Just come on over. We'll feed you.
So.
I'm awfully hungry.
I know, right?
We could eat quite a lot.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. So what I'm doing is I am putting my fork in here and I'm trying to twirl the squash as one might twirl pasta. Try and get that spaghetti effect.
Yeah.
It's not working out super great, but, you know, I try. So I may just do a lump of stuff.
Alright. Carve this into a shape of some sort.
Yeah, I'm rolling. I feel very confident we could feed at least 5 people with this meal.
At bare minimum.
So if you can find your way over here, you can have some of this.
If you can get here before we eat it all.
That's right. You heard
that's
it for me.
That's a stipulation.
You heard it for me.
All right. Okay. So, we've got our bed of kale.
Immediately our viewer count drops as BM Roland
jumps
in the car.
Just leaves. Bye!
Please, okay. Take me to deliciousness.
Right? Alright, I'm going to add a little more around the outside because I want kind of a border of kale.
Alright.
Alright, so I've got our spaghetti squash in the middle. Now we're going to move on to the meatballs and sauce.
I'm guessing I can't touch it with my bare hands.
I would not recommend that. Here, take this towel.
I'm going to use these.
Oh, yeah. The mitts!
Mitts.
Commit to the mitts.
The mitts of justice.
The mitts of justice. Right there in the corner.
Boy, that is an incredible amount of sauce.
Yes, it absolutely
is. Wow.
So I'm going to give this to you. To you.
Huh? Oh.
This to you. And if you could bring me the spoon.
Spoon man.
Spoon, you are now officially the spoon man. Trade you. You know the Spoon Man song? You would. Yes, shit, yeah. Alright. So, we're gonna start off.
Feel the rhythm with your hand.
Feel the rhythm
with your hand.
Spoon Man!
Spoon Man! Also, the spoon.
I think I just drank your beer.
You did, and did not also bring me my spoon.
I'm sorry. I need the
spoon.
Which spoon?
The one right in front of your
this
face.
This spoon?
That spoon.
I just brought you a spoon.
You brought me a fork.
No, I gave you the big spoon.
Oh, I didn't need that spoon.
And we started playing
Spoon
Man.
I needed the small spoon. All right, so I'm going to push. So for this, meatballs, I'm spoon, meatball. I'm going to push the spoon into the squash and make like a little divot so the meatball doesn't like roll around in it. And I'm going to do like 3 or 4 meatballs on this bitch. And then I'm going to slather the fucking thing in sauce. The silence is so tense. Okay.
The sound of silence.
Sound of food science? Oh, fuck yeah. Alright.
I keep having to bribe the sound guy with more seeds so he'll keep playing.
And the thing behind you. Normally I would do fresh Parmesan cheese, but I feel like we've done our due diligence in terms of effort. So I'm not gonna give myself too much shit. So I'm just gonna sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on tap, because it's not pasta if it doesn't have Parmesan. Thank you. And now we're gonna top this bitch off with some fucking seeds. Don't worry, I'm gonna add a shit ton more after I've taken a picture, because the amount of food I actually eat and the amount of food it looks like I eat are two vastly different things. Yeah, okay. So, I'm gonna give you guys the preview of the picture, and then I'm gonna try each of the ingredients so that you can see me like actually eat them and not die. So it occurs to me that this kind of looks like a Thanksgiving meal up close.
Mm.
It's not. But we've got our pasta on a bed of roasted kale with spaghetti squash and homemade meatballs. And this is officially our longest stream ever.
Ever!
Longest stream ever!
Ever!
Hooray! Hooray! Okay, so I'm gonna try these meatballs real quick, and also the kale, because it occurs to me that I haven't actually tried that yet. And because nothing is better than eating pasta with a fucking baguette. We literally just have a baguette. You could rip it up. You don't have to make garlic bread. You don't have to do anything fancy with it. Just have some fucking bread and eat it with your pasta. So, can you get me... I need some of this kale. Some of this kale. Oh.
Some more kale.
For my face.
For your face.
For my face. So that people can watch me eat the food and not be...
But I want kale for my face.
You can have kale for your face. Oh, fuck.
Yeah,
it's got like a salty charcoal...
It's basically chips.
God damn it, yes. I get kale chips now.
Yep.
I fucking get it now.
I do too.
What the... Okay, so now I'm going to actually have a meatball. Now I'm going to cut this up so that we can all have a meatball. So now you guys are fucking dying right now. I really wish I could get this up close, like... Babish is really big on, like, the cross-section. I really wish I could give that to you right now, because this ooze is insane.
It is very oozy.
Hella oozy.
So much ooze. What's the secret to the ooze?
The secret of the ooze is... garlic. I guess.
Hot. Delicious. Ecstatic.
Holy fuck.
Ecstasy driven meat.
It's very warm, but come have some.
Oh, I get to have some.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, there's two here.
There's one for you too, Seth.
Sweet.
Perks of being down here, you get to taste the food first.
Guys, this is the best part of the show. Mmm.
That's how a meatball's supposed to taste.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, sweet. You converted? Oh, my dear Lord. Okay. If all meatballs tasted like that...
You'd eat more meatballs?
I would
you'd
eat a
eat
lot.
More balls?
I would eat so many. I just have
yeah.
all the balls in my mouth 24/7.
Nice and juicy and meaty.
Yep.
All right, guys. Well, that was our stream for tonight. Thank you so much for hanging out. We still have 9 people watching
that's
right now.
That's fucking amazing.
You guys are fucking troopers.
My God. I don't even know how that's possible.
I really appreciate it.
3 hours.
I know these guys really appreciate it. I know Seth especially appreciates it because Spears are probably dying right now. But I will take pictures of the stuff and put it on the Facebook page. Come follow us on Facebook at The Pole Chef. Follow us on YouTube at The Pole Chef. Follow us on Twitch at The Pole Chef. Follow us everywhere except... the house.
Everywhere.
At the
well, yeah,
chef.
No, don't.
Come find us, follow us, share your recipes, tell your stories, join us, one of us, and we will be here every Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. For now, eat well, and have a good night!
Good night!
Thank you.
Somebody turn off the stream. Quick, go! There's a controller.
Oh, God.
I got it. All right, bye.